And yes, the rumors are true. They smoke, they drink, they use bad language and mixed company. They're extremely rich and they can flash more bling than most posses in this room. Rock stars they are, and God bless them for that.
You can call Don and Mike anytime, toll free at 1-877-365-3636. That's 1-877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you. Stop on the rock. Stop on the run. Stop on the run. Can't stop the run. Stop on the run.
Just people.
Stop on the run. Stop on the run.
Just people.
Stop on the run.
The Don and Mike show.
And they'll say what they will.
Where else would you rather be? Than right here, right now.
Who's Mr. Amtrak? Come on. There he is.
Yeah.
Come on, ride the train.
Ride it.
Good morning, Mr. and Mrs. Juicy Girls and all the ships at sea. Proudly clean and sober for well over 24 hours. It's the Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, thank you, Robbie.
Hello.
Thank you for listening, everybody. Don and Mike Show. A brand new episode on this Friday.
Friday.
It's November 9er.
Already. Wow.
So glad to be back in the most powerful city in the world, our home, Washington, D.C. And here are your phone numbers. National number from anywhere in America, 877-365-3636. And D.C., your hotline is 202-432-1067.
All right.
Today, oh, a glorious day it will be. Strip trivia, the final strip trivia of 2001. No surprise to Mike and I as we came down to the studio, got to the lobby.
Yes.
It's full of smelly, sweaty guys.
Yeah, like three or four guys here already. They've been here probably since 8 a.m.
Of course.
Been
assured that the girls are on their way here.
We've been assured before.
Yeah, I know.
Right.
We got a free break here. We're going to give the girls time to get here. We never actually start strip trivia in the first break of the show.
There are seriously traffic nightmares all over the city today.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Blower's been activated.
Excellent. Blower activated. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, I just wanted to thank you guys. You guys are excellent. I'm a truck driver. I'm just up here watching my
well, he got the good part out. That's good.
He had something nice to say, and then the phone just crapped out there. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Yes.
Turn your radio down, please. Hello?
Yes.
Hi, you're on the air.
What the hell?
I can get her.
All right.
Good luck.
How was that?
That was excellent.
Get out of here.
I can get her.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hi.
Hi, you're on the air.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
I love you guys.
Thank you. We're just...
Just people.
Hi.
I need to ask you a question.
Yes, honey.
What I want to do is sew some red, white, and blue ties together.
Is this Rush Limbaugh's wife?
No.
Oh, no.
Hi, honey. This is Rush Limbaugh.
Seems to be a little problem hearing.
What? Rush Limbaugh's wife, her business is she makes ties. She makes neckties.
I want red, white, and blue ties to sew a flag together.
Have you been drinking?
No.
Just okay. Checking.
All right, so you want red, white, and blue flags.
Ties.
To make into a flag.
Uh-huh. And if I get enough, I definitely want to take it to New York City.
Okay.
But I want to make another one for the Pentagon also.
Well, that's wonderful.
That is absolutely terrific.
Thank you. Betsy Ross checking in. Thank you, Betsy.
Hello,
Betsy?
So that the world will know that we are still tied together?
Gotcha. Brilliant, brilliant concept.
Thank you, Betsy. Hello, here's Dan concept. Don.
Born at the bottom of a vodka bottle.
Dan, Don and Mike Show. Hi there.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey, my friend.
I just want to say hello to my favorite radio star, Buzz.
Hello, sir. There you go. And I forgot
Did you
again.
Say hi to Buzz this morning?
I forgot. Someone always calls.
They remind me.
To say hello.
My peeps are out there.
Hello to...
hi, Don and Mike, and hello, sir.
Everybody's favorite DJ, Buzz Burbank.
Very good.
All right, Dan.
Buzz is God.
Mission accomplished. You got it. See you later. Thank you for the call. All right, today will be jam-packed because of strip trivia. Yeah. However, we do have a regular Friday feature on the show.
Yes.
Where we have a newsmaker come in.
Newsmaker on the spot.
Okay. And today, well, what can I say? I love it when we have a star athlete on the show.
Well, we had Cal Ripken a while back.
And we've had O.J. Simpson.
Right.
But today, joining us, perhaps the greatest manager of the last 10 years, we sure are excited to have joining us in the studio, a living legend. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the manager of your New York Yankees, Joe Torre.
Joe! Fantastic.
Joe, hi.
Hey, let's make this quick, asswipe. I've got an appointment for a facial at noon.
You're getting a facial?
Yeah, no ass, Sherlock. Every Friday, the grounds crew from Yankee Stadium fires up one of their big-ass lawn tractors, lowers the blade, and mows my face.
They mow your face?
Yes, Dick Weed. That's how I maintain my rugged good looks.
Dick
that,
Weed.
And I use makeup.
Joe Torre, you the manager of the Yankees. You use makeup?
Don't be shocked, Captain. I've learned a few beauty tips from another famous New Yorker. Tips that make me young and vibrant looking.
Makeup tips, from a New Yorker. Did you learn them from a supermodel?
No. I learned them from a fine broadcaster named Fez Watley.
Yeah. We know Fez from the Ron and Fez show.
Yes, you know, she's quite talented.
No, Joe, Fez is a man. I'm surprised you didn't know that.
Whatever. Bite me, asswipe.
All right. Joe Torre, let me start this interview. Seriously, may I ask you a tough question?
Yes, you're a total fag.
No. How could the unbeatable legendary Yankees lose the World Series to the Diamondbacks?
Good question.
Well, you know, the reasons we lost were multifold.
Okay, come on, let's get specific. Why'd you guys lose? Can you be more specific? Can you elaborate?
Of course, that's why. First off, we were all sick and tired of John Zimmer's incessant farting. For Christ's sake, you could hook up a Weber gas grill to his Duke and do some tailgating. Except for the fact that your burgers would taste like ass.
Now, come on, I know you're not being honest with me. There has to be another reason that the Yankees lost the World Series.
Well, Captain, you know, no one had cancer. In years past, we could play for Daryl Strawberry or maybe my brother Maury.
Oh, Maury Torre?
Yes, Maury got bit by the big C, and all of a sudden, we were the greatest. This year, we played like the Melwood softball team.
Did you ask anybody to try to get sick, to try to get it going again?
By God, we tried. By game five, Paul O'Neill and Scott Brosius were up to 3 packs a day. Yeah, but you know, no ugly answer K. Couldn't catch an effing break.
So no diseases at all, huh?
The only ailment we could muster is when Derek Jeter came to game two and his Duke was bleeding.
How did that happen?
How do you think? He says all he had was a cranberry juice.
So, all right, here's another real question for you. How is George Steinbrenner dealing with the World Series loss?
Oh, pitchy. He's a bigger a-hole than you. If such a thing is possible.
So, Joe, what will you do?
Well, Captain, I've had enough of this ass in the Big Apple, so I'm moving. I'm going to chase my dream elsewhere.
Oh, so what does that entail?
Well, I'm moving to Boston to manage the Red Sox. Now, there's a team that knows how to lose. Hey, by the way, hi, Mike O'Mara.
Hi, Joe. So, listen, Joe Torre, you know Mike O'Mara?
You bet, ass wife. I'm going to move to Boston and dedicate every loss to the Golden Ball. And you know what? If I really apply myself, we can be statistically eliminated by the All-Star break.
There you go, Joe. If you do that, Mike will hate you.
Oh, well, I'll email him an apology at johnnyfagola@aol.com. Or maybe go see Annie, get your gun.
Joe, be kind.
I'm kidding, of course.
Of course you are. That whole Johnny Fagula thing is a joke. Mike O'Mara is straight.
Yeah, but Yaz is a fag. Oh. Everyone knows it.
Oh, dear. Oh, all right. My. All right, Joe, back. Let's get back. Let's talk about New York. I'm a New Yorker at part-time. Let's get back to the Yankees.
Oh, sure. You go to your gay apartment 6 days a month, and all of a sudden, you're Mr. New York. Suck a D, asswipe.
Hey, be kind to me. I went to a playoff game against the A's at Yankee Stadium.
Yeah, of course. Sponging off that Arista record slime ball. Well, whoop to freaking do. How did you enjoy the house that Rats built?
The house that Rats built? No, it's the house that Ruth built.
You're kidding. You're mostly kidding. Are you kidding? Well, that place has more mice than a Gateway Computer Superstore. But thanks for the support, Johnny Come Lately. How'd you like the smell?
Oh, the smell of the stadium? It was all right, I guess.
Yeah, they made the foundation cement with stool and urine, and the concessions are of value.
Let's take that one again.
Say, it's hard to understand Joe's accent sometimes.
Yeah, how did I like the smell? It was okay, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
You enjoy the smell of urine?
No, he's ad-libbing now. I'm just going back to, how'd you like the smell? Okay, I suppose.
Oh, yeah, they made the foundation cement with stool and urine. And, oh, these concessions are of value.
Now, how do you mean the concessions are of value?
You haven't lived until you've had a $12 beer. Thank you, Mr. Steinbrenner. Our crap is so overpriced, we get fan letters from Daniel Snyder.
Now, I saw some good stuff. Can you tell me? I saw some good values. Are there any good souvenir values at Yankee Stadium?
Well, $80 gets you the Don Zimmer hemorrhoidal seat cushion. It really protects your anal jewels.
Don Zimmer.
No kidding.
Yep. It comes in your choice of Yankee blue pinstripe or Zimmer brown.
Now, wait a minute. Hold on. Brown isn't a Yankees color.
It is after Don Zimmer uses it.
Oh my.
Actually, it's sort of a reddish brown.
All right, Joe, come on. You're out of the playoffs. What are your plans for November?
Well, how about Roger Clemens and I come down to your sock studio and throw fastballs at your crotch?
Wow, he's so hostile.
Now, I don't like that.
Oh, how about I get David Justice to shove a Louisville slugger right up your big, fat...
Hey, cool it, Joe.
Oh, sorry, Captain. I just get upset because I hate your show.
All right, understood. So what was it like to lose in Game 7?
Well, it was a mixture, a rich cocktail of emotions, if you will.
Please explain.
Well, as a positive, we got congratulatory phone calls from Mayor Giuliani and President Bush.
Well, that's nice.
But in the sadness column, there was a real feeling of emptiness at my private after party.
Oh, you had a private after party?
Yep. Just a simple, intimate affair by 7 guys, you know, just people.
Who was there? As if I didn't know.
Well, me, Carl Ripken Jr., Tony Siragusa.
Oh, no.
Yeah, Rush Limbaugh, Dan Rather, O.J. Simpson, Vice President Dick Cheney.
All right, so what happened at the party, Joe?
Well, suffice it to say, a grunge rule double shot through my pinstripes. I shout, fair ball! Now I've got full-blown AIDS.
Oh, no.
Oh, that's a sad turn of events. That's really horrible.
Not near as bad as this show. You suck, Captain Asswipe.
Well, Joe, thank you for joining us.
F you. Your show sucks.
Joe!
Interview over. Good day to you, sir.
But Joe Torre.
I said good day.
There he goes. All right, there you go. There's the the newsmaker hotline today.
Joe Torre.
It was Joe Torre of the New
Bye,
York
Joe.
Yankees.
Bye. See you later, Joe.
Great seeing him.
Bye-bye.
Everybody loves Joe Torre. He was,
he's Mr. Yankee.
Yeah, newsmaker of the week.
Fantastic.
That's what you get here on the Don and Mike Show. Every week, we'll bring you the biggest headliner that we can find.
Very, very exciting, and glad to know he's going to be managing the Red Sox.
Okay, on to the next item.
Okay.
Hold on, here we go. Jonathan. Hey, Jonathan. Hi, Don and Mike Show.
Good morning, Don. Good morning, Mike.
Hey,
I was trying to ask Joe, is the reason the Yankees didn't win this year because they didn't have a substantial tragedy on one player on the team? You know, 1 year with Strawberry, it's cold.
Well, they addressed that in the interview.
We had that in the interview. No one had cancer this year.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I guess that...
Oh, hold on. That line just went dead.
There was nothing to rally around and not downplay this or make light of it all, but, you know, the tragedy of September 11th, I mean, I was driving to work and saw it when it happened. That might have been just a little too much on everybody to overcome. The oversized unit and the bull they call Kurt Schilling.
Thank you. Okay, bye-bye.
That was a serious sports call. Very right. Serious.
Following a very serious interview.
Absolutely. We got another guy with a joke on the line.
They don't learn.
You know they don't. Who's this, Anthony?
Hey, what's up?
Anthony, where are you from?
I'm from Edison, New Jersey, the king-size Reese's guy.
All right, the king-size Reese's guy. Now, I've already got the phone number here. Is this the number?
Yes, you got it.
All right, hold on. I'm going to call you right back.
Okay.
You know the drill.
I know the drill.
If the joke is not funny...
I think you'll like it.
If the joke doesn't make us laugh, we'll give out the phone number on the air.
Not a problem.
Hold on. I'll call you right back.
Okay.
You know, it's interesting. When they say, I think you'll like it, there's always a little chance, just a tiny chance... Uh-huh. But usually not much.
Because generally on the show, when people call to tell jokes, unless we're doing a segment like Make Us Laugh, it doesn't work a lot. So if you really have if you've got the conviction in your material,
the verve,
you will put your phone number on the line.
This guy's willing to take the risk, I guess.
Now he seemed to be having some difficulty with the phone line.
Stupid long distance code.
Yeah. It's a Melco telephone.
Yep.
You can't make a long-distance call without putting your special code in.
It's all right. We're just trying to do a show.
I got him now. It's Anthony.
Anthony.
Here he is.
Hello.
Anthony. Okay, you're on the air.
Hey, by the way, I love your show.
Thanks. We appreciate it. Go ahead.
All right. What are hillbillies doing on Halloween?
I don't know. What do hillbillies do on Halloween?
Pumpkin.
We had it.
Old joke. We had it.
Jeez. All right, Anthony.
Christ, Anthony.
Anthony's phone number at home, everybody.
All right.
Area code 732. 748-8819.
All right, thanks, guys.
All right, thanks, Anthony.
Thank you.
Have a nice weekend.
Again, that's 732. Yeah, it's a bad idea to do this on a Friday show.
Very, very bad.
732-748-8819.
And send him your red, white, and blue ties.
When will people learn?
Sometime in the Anthony household this weekend, you will hear over the phone Anthony saying, what do you mean you can't come out on Sunday?
Now, I know a lot of you probably wonder... Don, you're so fantastic. We got to hear every bit of your life. Tell me how are things going?
How are things going?
How are things going?
Don, how are things going?
Well, I will tell you that last night when I arrived home, I had scorn on the cob, and when I woke up this morning, I had a big bowl of scorn flakes.
I know when I was leaving you at the train, I said, "Well, how are things going on the home front?" You said you'd let me know in 24 hours.
Right. And here's the deal it was. I had some scorn chips.
Oh, delicious scorn chips.
And leftover from Halloween, I had some candy scorn.
Did you have any cream scorn?
Yes, cream scorn. Had it all last night. Got a little more this morning. Here's the deal. We're getting on the...
scorn dog.
We're getting on the train yesterday, and my wife's on the phone, and I say hi, and she goes, hi. And right away, I know that... Something ain't right.
Something's amiss.
Right? And I say, what's the deal? And she says, I don't know. I just feel I'm insecure. I say, well, why are you insecure? She says, well, you know, you've been up in New York a couple of days, and then we haven't seen each other this week. I'm like, yeah. She goes, and you haven't had me on the show in a while. Now, keep in mind, this is the same woman who, you know, says to me, hey, I could live without being on the show. You don't have to put me on the show. I put her on the show because I like having her on the show for whatever reason. So, and apparently she's mad that when I was describing the events of last weekend when we had people come over, she didn't like the way I told that story.
Mm-hmm.
And I think she wanted to get her 2 cents in.
Very good.
So I'm going to call her now, and let's see what's up with my child bride.
This one. Hello.
Hey, hi, baby.
Who's this?
Oh, come on.
Yeah, wait, hi.
Come on.
I was fired.
Come on. What do you mean? See, this is what I got.
I know. You know what? I can live without being on the show, but I know that, but it's reassuring to me, not for, you know, this it's an unpaid position, not for job security, but for, you know, that I know you're thinking about me when you call me.
All right, listen.
On and off there.
As I explained to you, we had busy shows all week, and then her answer to that is...
You're usually not busy. Like, you're usually reading books while you're on the air. Like, you're usually getting pedicures.
Listen to this. So then I said, well, you know, you weren't on the air there for a week because you were at jury duty. And then what I wanted to talk to her about...
2.5 days, really.
What I wanted to talk to her about with the jury duty, she couldn't talk about on the air. She can talk about it now.
Well, you can talk about anything else, but, I mean, you just couldn't talk to me about that.
Well, that was interesting, though. I mean, that's something...
Well, like everything else I say is boring.
No, all right, come on. Settle down, honey. Settle down.
Well...
We're going to get all of this worked out right here.
You go out of town, and I talk to you, and you don't call me when you come in from your wild night of bowling, and I call you the next morning way past your usual wake-up time, and this is what I hear. Hello.
Yeah, well, we were out late on on Wednesday night.
Well, I think you would.
It was a festive evening.
Yeah, you wouldn't like it if I were out late and woke up with that voice, that hello voice.
And incidentally, you know the late time that she called and she got that voice, 7:15.
Ah,
seven.
Well, then you didn't call me back.
Well, I went back to sleep.
Well, then you didn't call me back later on. You said you went and worked out. Like I'm supposed to believe that?
I told you I went for a walk.
Yeah, that's you. You never go for a walk with me. I've asked you for 20 years to go for a walk, and you don't call me and say, and at least tell me that you're going
to
do that.
Listen to this.
It was all very fishy.
I've got to, you know, I got to have some kind of a low jack installed.
Satellite tracking device,
right in my nutsack. I got to have a low jack installed. So I go through all this with her. And so anyway, let's get to the issues that we've got to get to. Jury duty. Now this is something I wanted you to talk about. You were worried at first that you couldn't talk about it.
I still, you know, I was never clear on what I'm allowed to say and what I'm not allowed to say about jury.
The trial's got to be over.
Yeah,
I mean,
it was two weeks ago. Right. They said you can't say anything while the trial is going on. And so, of course, I didn't. I mean, I didn't even tell you things I think I'm allowed to say. You know, I think I'm allowed to, I thought I was allowed to say at the time it wasn't a criminal suit, it was a civil suit. I didn't even tell you that much because I didn't.
This is not real fair to you to say you can't say anything until the trial's over, and then you have no earthly idea of knowing whether the trial's over or not.
Yeah, and let me ask you this, Mike. Didn't you watch, you were like me and you watched the O.J. trial.
Yeah,
O.J.
Once the jurors were kicked off, couldn't they say?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
So listen, it's not legally binding unless you sign something.
Listen to how funny this is. So she's going into jury duty. This is a week and a half ago.
Oh, gosh, and jury duty is the worst. I used to think it'd be interesting to be a lawyer, but it's so boring, so repetitious.
So she goes in every day, and it's like, I'm, you know, we have the two-way pager things, and she's paging me like, oh, this is so boring,
right.
I hate this, and I'm writing her back, going, oh, baby, I'm sorry, I love you, don't, you'll get through it. Well, all of a sudden, out of the blue, one of the days that she's supposed to be at court, she comes here to the studio, because the court is right down the street. And they call down the front desk. I pick up the phone, and they go, your wife is here. I said, huh. No, you must be looking for Mike. That's impossible.
Right.
My wife is at jury duty. And they said, no, Frida's downstairs. So she comes up. And I'll tell everybody, this is funny what they did to my wife.
Well, it was like the third day of the trial, and I'm in the jury room with all the other jurors, and the bailiff comes and gets just me and brings me into the courtroom in which all the people involved are there, all the lawyers, all the complainants, the defendants, you know, all the judge, and they swear me in. And do you swear tell the whole truth? Yes. You know, well, would you get in the witness box? Okay.
Oh, my God. And they don't tell you what the deal is?
No. No.
Are you freaked out?
No, because I've, you know, my life, because of my marriage, has been unusual for quite a few years. So it's just like, you know, all right, what happened? What, you know, what's going on? So, no, I mean, I roll with it. I just say, sure. I know I haven't done anything wrong. I don't know what they want me for, but I've been good. So they send me in there, and then the judge starts asking, telling me what's happened on the show, what's been, you know, quoting the show to me. And I haven't been able to listen because I've been in jury duty. I mean, I haven't been near a radio. I've been, you know, and he said, have you told your husband anything about this trial? I said, absolutely not. The only reality there is that I'm not sequestered because I assume you're celebrating you're mourning the fact, actually, that I'm not going to be, you know, sequestered, and it's going to be a real vacation at home.
Right.
And I said, and that I'd be busy for a week or week and a half. I mean, otherwise, no, he does a comedy radio show.
She didn't tell me anything, but listen to this. They had transcripts
of our show.
And they're reading the show to me.
Now, and tell them some of the stuff that they were reading.
And you know what? It always makes you feel funky when they do your real name and the AKA name. You know, like...
Michael Source, AKA Don Geronimo.
Like, you always feel like, you know, you're not quite legit when they do that to you anyway.
Because, I'm the only DJ in the world who uses a fake name.
So they actually had transcripts there.
And so, right. And then the lawyers are questioning me. And not just the judge. And so then they take me into a separate room so I won't taint the jury with my presence.
Now, hey, baby, when the transcripts were read, what did they read to you?
You said something about going to haul the guy away in an orange jumpsuit and all this. Whatever doofy thing you were saying that day. I'm just shaking my head and trying not to smile.
I can't imagine you couldn't smile. Yeah. So you didn't smile. That's hysterical.
No.
Was anybody
serious? And they're telling me how serious this is.
So nobody was laughing and nobody was smiling?
No. Nobody's
God.
Smiling.
No, keep in mind again, I'm in the dark about this. I don't know where she's going to be in this trial.
I haven't said anything to you.
My wife's on jury duty. That's all I know.
And they're asking me if the other jurors know, you know, if I've said anything to them. Like I said, no, I usually don't brag about my husband's job. The other jurors don't even think they know, we didn't even exchange first names. We've been chatting, but it's all been, bland chatting.
But then the great news is that they pull her in this room, and then how did they cut you loose?
Well, see, then they're still in the courtroom for 20 minutes while I'm in the separate room and all by myself, so I don't taint the jury. So then they bring me back in and they say, Mrs. Source, it's not that we disbelieve you, but audio is actually, they said, but goodbye. We don't want you.
Isn't that great? That's how you get out of jury duty.
Was it embarrassing at all?
Well, then it was kind of, because I had to go get my coat and my purse and everything and gather it up from the jury, and I couldn't tell anybody why I'd been kicked off. I said to everybody, I'm sorry for any inconvenience, I said this to the judge, and then I went and gathered out my stuff, and I couldn't tell why I'd been kicked out of school. They don't know what I've done that's bad.
Wow. Because your dumb husband talked about it on the radio. Right. But I didn't even know the facts. That's what was so funny. Yeah. And I'm picturing Frida sitting in the L.A. law thing, sitting up there, do you swear to tell the whole truth? And they're reading a transcript. They've taped the show.
Yeah.
Pretty amazing.
Cool.
Your husband said, why, my wife, if found guilty, will put him in an orange jumpsuit with leg irons on.
It's amazing that somebody was actually paying that much attention that they taped the show.
I don't even know. There was one bailiff there who passed me a note a day or two earlier asking if I was, if I was Don Geronimo's wife, because he recognized my voice, surprisingly. But no one else, there was no way of even knowing that I was connected.
What dopes they are.
It seems odd because they knew who she was when they put her on the jury, so it seems odd that they would put her on the jury at all, especially if they were going to react as negatively that quickly.
No, but they didn't. They didn't know who I was. I mean, I just, used my legal name.
When this happened to you, I think we had this similar discussion that when any of us now are called on jury duty,
I'm your friend.
We simply say, well, if I'm on your jury, the fact that I'm on this jury is going to be discussed on the radio.
Correct.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mind taking the bullet. You guys just say.
I'd do the same thing for you.
We work on a show where we talk about everything.
Don's on jury duty today. Let me tell you, he's the hanging juror.
Yeah, right.
You're toast if you've got him on the jury, and then the phone rings half hour later. Well, I get back over to the studio.
And I only hope that by mentioning this, I don't F up the next legal battle that we're going to be fighting, and that, of course, is my wife's speeding ticket.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm getting to know the courthouse pretty well now.
But she got a couple of days ago. We're almost to the point that our insurance rates are finally going to go down. We're
hoping they go down before we have to put Bart through college.
Yeah.
Right now, it's eating away at his fund.
We're almost to the level we can see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah.
And boom, right there, she gets hit with a big speeding thing.
And don't you hate it when it's right on the line? I mean, it just made it into the next category of lots of points.
Yeah.
I think it's,
20 okay. There's a word for that, isn't there? It's the R word, isn't it? Yes. They gave you on that when you go past that certain limit?
No, right? No, I wasn't reckless.
Well, I mean, it's a technicality. I mean, I hate to diminish it and say it's a but it is technicality that goes up to a certain level.
In Virginia, over 20 over.
20
I
over.
Yeah. I wasn't even 20 over. I was 15
over. Oh, you're
lucky.
Johnny
said you were doing like 60 and a 30.
I thought you were 25 over.
No, I was doing 50 and a 35. It's 15.
Well, then what's the word?
You're fine,
that's standard.
I think that's about 4 points. I mean, you guys know better.
What it is where the one time I was doing over 20, that it kicks it up directly.
Well, honey, I thought it was. I thought you said 25. Because why would it be 4 points for going 50 and a 35?
That's what the policeman thought it was. He wasn't sure, but he told me he thought it was 4 points.
Go to the Virginia DMV website, which is one of the best there is, and it'll tell you exactly how many
points.
Is that
on your favorites, Buzz?
Yeah, I've got it bookmarked. I use it regularly.
Yeah.
All right, so that's item number two.
Item number three.
The number three is what I'm going to a wild card I'm going to throw at you.
Wild.
It's a wild card that I just want to say to your sister. It's about friggin' time. Okay, that's all I want to say. It's about friggin' time.
Hey,
can I guess?
After you haven't called me for a long time on the air, and then get me in trouble with my family.
I'm not getting you in trouble with your family.
Somebody else doing dinner.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, you know what?
My sister-in-law, Judy.
Sugar Bear, we have no family events at our house.
But we have Thanksgiving every year.
That's our one token thing. My brother Doug does every family.
I know, and that's the way I like it. But your sister Judy never has Thanksgiving at her house, and I got the great news when I came home yesterday that finally, I just want to say, Judy, you know, hey, it's about friggin' time.
Yeah, you'd probably be at some bowling alley anyway on Thanksgiving.
No, I'll be there with you. Now, listen, I know that you had issue with me about the comments I made when we had the people come over last weekend. We watched the World Series, and we had people come over for dinner.
It was just a little show critique.
All right, go ahead.
Well, I understand that that you are an entertainer, and so you might
full-time entertainer.
Huh?
Full-time entertainer.
Yeah, a full-time
20 years
entertainer.
Worth. 25 so years worth.
You might exaggerate a little bit on my behavior when you're on the air, and I understand that, and I can deal with it. It's not real life. It's what, you know, it's comedy.
Yeah.
However, when you are relaying things that happen to us in our relationship, and that's okay, and you exaggerate my behavior to make it funnier, okay again.
Such as what?
But you turn you into Father Knows Best.
Well.
And I'm maniacal. So if you're going to exaggerate your own behavior.
What? For instance?
For instance, you said... I was getting ready to have people over for dinner Saturday night. I called you and I heard you say Jesus Christ on the air because I was asking. I was on my way to the grocery store and did we have this and did we have that?
Yes, and I said that I don't do anything when people come over.
No, you didn't say it then. But you said and you had me checking on tomatoes and you had me doing this and then how I overreacted and didn't speak to you or in this kind of thing.
That's true. You hung up the phone on me.
All right. No, I hung up the phone and I turned it off, and that's okay. And you exaggerated my reaction, my anger, but
I did not.
I did not ask you if we had tomatoes or if we had this. All I asked you to do is move your butt approximately 10 feet to the bar to see if we had whiskey, which was I was doing you a favor by doing your one token errand anyway.
I don't drink whiskey.
You said you were going to the liquor store to get more stuff for martinis.
Right, because we were having people over.
I was doing you a favor and doing your errand, and you couldn't move your ass from your couch to the bar to tell me what I needed to buy without it being like a giant effort. And then when I asked you again, you got impatient with me because I said, are you sure we don't have scotch? I thought for sure we have scotch. No, all we have is whiskey. And then I go home, and we have like five bottles of scotch that we've never had to drink.
Pardon me that I'm not a full-blown alcoholic, that I don't know all the different kinds of booze.
You can't read. That you can't read the label.
No, here's the deal. She says to me, do we have... What did you ask me? If we had whiskey and what else?
I said, do we have whiskey? I said, do we have scotch and do we have bourbon?
Okay.
That's all I said. And you said, no, all we have is whiskey.
Whiskey. Right. I said, I look at the bottles.
Whiskey. All you want.
I look at the bottles. I count them. I go, honey, we got 5 bottles of whiskey.
You can't read the word scotch on there.
Well, now, if it's scotch, why does the bottle say whiskey?
Because scotch is whiskey, the kind. Bourbon and scotch are...
Then why ask
for
the...
There's Canadian whiskey. There's different kinds.
There's Irish whiskey.
Yeah, do we have scotch and do we have bourbon? That was all I wanted to know. And
there's
that's where I hear...
whiskey.
Jesus Christ, because you're moving your butt.
Well, no, see, do you understand my deal? My deal is I get up and I go to the liquor cabinet and I look. And now I'm looking for a bottle that says scotch. Okay? I don't know anything about... The only hard liquor I know about is vodka.
Look, the label's not going to say scotch, only scotch. This is what Frida's asking about. Tell her if you have scotch, dummy. It's not going to say all that.
Okay, so I come back to the phone and I say, we have 5 bottles of whiskey. And she says, well, that's impossible.
That's impossible. We don't have... we have to have scotch. I know people have given us
scotch. And now I've looked at the bottles and they say whiskey.
They say scotch.
And at that point she says... go look again, which is why at that point I got up, and as I was leaving, I said, when I got out of the hallway, Jesus Christ, because I know I've already looked at these bottles 5 times.
Didn't see scotch on there.
They say whiskey. Well, no.
And they say scotch, and you were wrong, and all I hear is Jesus Christ because you're having to move around.
Well, now, you know, it's a technicality that if whiskey and scotch are really the same thing, then why didn't you just ask me if we have whiskey?
Because there's other kinds of whiskey. I'm asking you if we had scotch.
See,
why couldn't
scotch,
you say to me...
Scotch, bourbon, Irish, Canadian, blended, those are all whiskeys.
Yeah.
Well, when people came over, how many people had any kind of whiskey that night?
The point is, people do drink that, don't they?
How many of our house guests had any kind of whiskey at all?
Don't some people like scotch?
Yeah. How many people at our house that night had any kind of whiskey at all?
You couldn't tell. How am I supposed to know that, Kreskin?
No, could you? You were there, Mrs. Kreskin.
No, before the party. How am I supposed to know that nobody's going to? And why couldn't you say some of the bottles say scotch on them? Would that be taxing to your eyes to read 2 words instead of one?
No, Johnny Walker Red is your pretty standard scotch whiskey.
Well, see,
your Jack Daniels is your pretty standard.
I'm just a dope.
Bourbon.
I don't know.
You're not a dope. You don't know about booze.
I thought whiskey's one thing and scotch is another thing.
You're a dope because you couldn't read the word scotch on it.
Okay.
I don't drink this stuff. I can read.
Okay.
And you don't give me that Jesus Christ thing when I'm in my preparing for getting ready for people coming over doing you a favor mode.
Wait. How are you doing me a favor?
Because you were going to the liquor store, and I'm saving you the grueling...
But I think
Jack Daniels is more of a scorn liquor.
But you did this favor without asking me. I mean, I was planning on going to the liquor store later in the day.
And I was doing you a favor.
Yeah, but see, you didn't give me the opportunity to do it myself. You just went out
did
it.
Is that wrong, to do you a favor before you ask me?
Well, is it wrong then to hold it over my head that you're busting my balls because I didn't do something that you're doing when you didn't even give me the chance to do it?
I was being nice, but you give me Jesus Christ because you had to go look because you were wrong.
No. I gave you Jesus Christ because I looked for scotch and all I saw was whiskey.
Yes, and you were wrong. I mean, you were wrong, and so you act like, why am I bothering you by asking you again?
See, hasn't everybody missed my wife on the show for the last couple of days?
I have.
You know, that's why I miss you when you're in New York.
I know, but as soon as I get home, you hate me again.
Well, no, I don't hate you, but it does make me feel good to be usually right when you're usually wrong.
All right, sweetie. I love you.
Sure you do.
Oh, come on now.
All right.
Come on.
All right.
Okay. Come on. Throw some love my way.
I love you.
All right, thanks, baby.
All right, goodbye.
All right, bye-bye. So that's what's happening in my house.
Everything's fixed now. There was a moment there. There's always a moment there, like when it starts really getting turbocharged.
Right.
Or, you know.
She was all wound up.
She had a lot to get off her chest.
Yeah. I got to let her on the show a little bit more, I think. Otherwise, I got to go through that at home. And I'd rather go through it here with everybody else.
It's a pressure valve. It's a release valve.
She released a lot of steam. I don't think it's over yet, but I think she got a lot out of her system. Mm-hmm. No, I think we covered all the major points. I think we got it covered. I think I'm in.
You think you made for a good weekend now?
Oh yeah, I'm gonna have a great weekend.
There you go.
We're gonna have.
Well, that's all you need.
There you go. We're gonna have one hell of a weekend.
Super.
Who am I kidding? My weekend is gonna be full of ass.
Scorn.
No. I mean SHI because it's. You know, I told you my kid is going to all these homecomings.
Right.
Well, this weekend my kid is going to the homecoming at his school, and guess who the lucky parents are who have volunteered their home as the after party.
Yeah, well, that's like you went to an after party a while. He went to one, and now you're doing it, huh?
Yeah, we're hosting it. So.
Well, you know, let's keep a good line on him, I guess. No, you know, it keeps him keeps you aware of what's going on.
Pain in the ass. It just takes away from my quality time of doing nothing.
Right.
Clear the lines out now. 877-365-3636.
A friend of mine told me that one of the reasons that's so tough when your kids get older, is because you have to be the parents.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
You know, if you could, like, enjoy the party, too, but you can't because you've got your role.
Can't. I got to be down there, turn all the lights on, you know, like, right. Go down every 15 minutes and make sure that nothing's happening.
And it's not like you can even have your friends over.
Oh, no, absolutely not.
Because you're there supervising the kids.
Correct.
Right? Really, like being a prison guard.
877-365-3636-202-432-1067. Thank you for helping me keep my marriage alive. When we come back, we'll have a call 100, and then we'll meet the contestants for today's Strip Trivia. We'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
I ain't seen a beat like that since somebody stuck a banana in my pants and turned a monkey loose.
Thanks for the pick-me-up, Eddie.
Your one source for Angry Red Snapper, the Don and Mike Show.
Right, right. Okay, it's call 100 time. And here we go. Hey, hello there, Don and Mike Show.
Hello, I'm call 100. Ha,
yeah.
Ha, ha.
Yeah, right. Hi, who's this?
This is Greg Jackson.
Hi, Greg. Where are you from?
From Annette.
Call 100, my friend. You won the Dunkin' Donuts. And the Dunkin' Donuts prize pack. Stop by Dunkin' Donuts. Get your favorite donuts. You'll never be disappointed. We love Dunkin' Donuts. Enjoy. Thank you, my friend.
Thank you.
Thank you for listening to the show. Got to mention, the winner of the Mercedes key yesterday.
Very exciting.
You know, we had lots of people show up at the Simply Wireless location at Montgomery Mall.
Excellent.
And, let me try to call and see if I can tell the person that they won a key.
Now, this is someone who was put in, like, the hopper.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to let them know now because their name was selected from all the people that dropped by yesterday?
Right.
Very good.
Except I'm sure you got to do this stupid, do I have your permission to go on the air thing?
Hi there.
Give me a second.
There you go. Permission, please.
I got it figured out.
Beg your pardon, ma'am.
I'm hearing the phone ring now.
Ringing.
Ring, ring, ring.
It's probably a home number, though.
Home.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
There's the machine.
Yeah. Well, we can leave the message for her, though.
Sure.
Yes. Okay. Here we go. Okay. Oh, I'm not going to leave the letter or message. Oh, come on.
Hey, it's me, Dave. I've been doing some early Christmas shopping, and I came across a gift that would be perfect for the people who listen to your show. Earplugs.
Oh man! Hello, this must be.
You know, sometimes what? I get so funny I crack myself up.
All right, shut up, Dan. This must be Lori Deckelbaum from Rockville, Maryland.
Hello, Lori.
Lori, Don and Mike Show here. Lori, congratulations. We are proud to tell you that you won the Simply Wireless prize pack and one of only 29 keys.
Yay!
That could start the Mercedes-Benz C230 that we're giving away on Friday, December 14th.
Congratulations, Lori Deckelbaum.
Thank you, Lori, and I guess someone will be calling you.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
Good luck.
Thank you for going to the store. That's how you do it. We do that every once in a while, just to give more people a chance to win. We'll give a location. You go there. You just fill out the form. You don't got to do anything except fill out the form.
Absolutely.
And then you're in. Now, strip trivia. We have a problem that, frankly, we're used to having.
Yeah, we've gotten this problem before, and it happens, and we deal with it.
Mm-hmm. There are about 12 guys here. And there's one girl here.
One.
Oh, one girl here.
Right. That's an attrition rate of 90%.
One girl here.
Wow. Now, that's not good.
No. Now, we can't do that because, although we like the gay community,
yes.
We're not doing a homo version of strip trivia.
No, and one woman
is not going to cut it. Now, Lisa has informed us that there's one woman here and I believe three that are in transit, but that is still not thick enough.
And the lady from New York, I believe she's in Baltimore. Is that what happened? Hey, Lisa, would you come here? Hey, Rummy. Give us an update on the...
Yeah, because this changes moment to moment, and we'll find out whether anything has changed out in the lobby. Check on the latest.
The very latest. Here now is Rummy Herndon.
Hi.
Who is today clean and sober.
Thank you. And, 24
looking,
hours.
Looking now? Much more perky than she was yesterday.
Thank you.
Rum, what's the latest?
The woman from New York, indeed, did call from Baltimore. She's on her way here. She should be here any moment.
Okay.
There's one lady here, and I have one or two others that should be here momentarily.
So four total, three or four total.
Correct.
Still not thick enough.
No.
No.
I mean, if we have to, we'll go four on four.
We'll go four on four, but we would like to really get the full complement of five.
Mm-hmm. You got to do it, because we've got... Seriously, like 1,000 guys in the lobby.
Oh, you might find it unusual. It has been our experience on Strip Trivia that women who enjoy removing their clothes tend to lack punctuality.
That's odd. I sure do.
Mm-hmm.
And I know what the answer for that is. What did Rob say the other day? That his new way of talking to Carrie?
What was it? Oh, yeah, he kisses each knuckle?
No. It's time to start counting knuckles.
Counting knuckles.
Time to start counting knuckles.
You know, with a youngster, I know it's popular to count to five. But with a wife, you just count the knuckles. And once you get to five,
oh, God.
I think Rob. It helps. It helps a lot of people.
Rob.
Helps me remember my numbers, my numerals.
Oh, goddamn. The prize today, of course, is the
he jokes like that. He jokes like that, and then Carrie gets him home and pushes him down the stairs.
The prize...
Oh, poor boy.
The prize for Strip Trivia is the key that can start the Mercedes, one of the only 29 keys, and also a vacation, if you can call it such, to Greensboro, North Carolina. But actually, it's great to go to see the WWF Survivor Series.
Yes, it is.
And that's courtesy of Comcast and Cox Cable.
Are you saying that walk-ins are welcome now, Don?
Absolutely, Mike.
Okay, well, this is an opportunity. If you have been on the fence about Strip Trivia, you know, we're going to accept walk-ins off of the street.
But you girls, you streetwalkers, you got to get down here, like, within the next, 2 minutes.
Right now.
You got to be here, because we absolutely got to start Strip Trivia just any second.
We've had this happen before, and normally what happens is in about 20 minutes or so, it's just, we get a little last-second tidal wave.
Yeah, it'll be bedlam, so bear with us on this.
If it doesn't, we get very angry. We've never canceled it, though, have we?
No.
We've threatened to cancel it.
Because our listeners have always come through.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you think we should do Rob's knuckle trick? Do you think we should?
We should threaten to cancel it now.
Threaten to cancel it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, we're threatening. Although, this is like
scary threat.
No,
it is.
We mean it. If
there's still one woman in the lobby in a half an hour, we're not doing it.
Oh, we can't. A half hour is not. It's too long.
Are you going to say like
20 minutes? 15 minutes.
Whoa!
Oh, my God, are we going to say 10 minutes?
No, I understand. What I'm saying is maybe a half hour would be fair.
A half hour?
25. Oh, Jesus, 25
I look at that clock. Yeah, I know. We got some weird-ass bass-ackwards clock in the studio.
I think Wendell brought it in.
Where the numbers are actually printed backwards and the clock runs backwards.
Mm-hmm.
All right, a compromise. I give you 25 minutes.
Okay, 25 minutes from right now.
25 minutes from now, or listen, really.
I mean, we won't do it.
I ain't kidding. We won't do it.
That's right.
Okay?
He's serious. He means it.
No. Listen to me. I'm not like George Bush. I'm not going to drop leaflets when I should drop bombs.
Exactly.
Okay? Mm-hmm. I mean it.
I know you mean it.
Do you mean it?
You're damn right I mean it.
Okay. No Strip Trivia. How you like that?
And you know, we're as disappointed as the listening audience when we don't do it. My God, we enjoy it more.
Hurt, bordering on angry.
And we got it. We got to get the girls. And Rob, have you started the count already on your knuckles? Is this how you do it with Carrie?
Up to number three, ladies.
Oh, he's on number three knuckle.
You should see him standing here, balling that giant ham hock into a fist. And
that's
actually counting one, three.
And let me tell you something. I've seen this boy throw a bowling ball.
Oh, it's true.
Oh, he's... God, that's got to be horrible
Kiss
to watch.
Kiss the pins.
Hello there, Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, I was just calling to see when you're going to give away Lisa's pregnancy test.
Oh, I totally forgot about
that. We didn't throw that away, did we?
No.
I think it's still on the shelf in John's office.
No. It's still in New York.
It's in New York.
Well, it's important, you know. You need to get that out and give it away as a prize to somebody.
Oh, do you want it?
No, not really, no.
No? You
sure? I was just wondering how many people are going to call and ask you actually want it.
Well, if you want it, I'll give it to you.
No, that's okay. I'll do without.
All right, but you're interested, though.
We can dip something else in the stream.
You know, you've been thinking about it, sir.
Constantly.
Yeah,
Maybe Lisa could just send you a beaker.
Okay. No, and I also just wanted to say I listen to you guys every single day.
Well, thank you.
I think your show's great.
Thanks, we appreciate that.
But I do think you need to give that away sometime, so.
All right. Thank you, my friend.
He'd like to see that.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I guess a beaker might not be legal to send that through the mail.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, Don.
Maybe we can give away some of her tampons or something.
Oh. Hey, Don.
Some of her TP.
Mike, how you doing?
Hi, you're on the air.
Yeah, hey, why don't you make the prize a bottle of booze, and then maybe Lisa will join in.
That's pretty good.
All right, thank you.
Yep.
Thank you, my friends.
They're dangling in front of her.
Come on, play the game.
Come on now.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Don't cancel strip trivia.
Well?
No.
It's tough love. You know what? You're making light of the situation, but I'm telling you, this is a real threat.
We've made this threat before.
No.
We have never had to carry out this threat, but we have made it with all sincerity that we will not do it. I mean, that is the way it works.
Now, I know that we didn't pimp like we normally do for like 3 or 4 days, but let's face it, this is one of the best prizes we've ever had, the key for the car and the WWF Survivor trip.
Exactly. And if strip trivia gets called off, that just means the terrorists win.
Yeah. Amen. Because, strip trivia.
Well, listen, do you have a sister? Do you have a girlfriend?
I have a wife.
Well, see, you're calling up and crying, and you're cluttering up that phone line.
You can help. What you should do is...
No, she could make it there in a half an hour.
Well, she could if she pulled a Frida if she sped. All right, my friend. See you later. Bye-bye.
What am I going to do with this beach towel now?
Just put your wife on a broom and send her over here. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, Don and Mike.
Yeah, hi.
I'm calling about Lisa's pregnancy test.
You want it?
Well, actually, I'd rather have a pair of her panties.
Oh, dear. Well, don't get greedy.
Lisa's got lots of fans out there. I think we're going to... Oh, Rob, you're up to what already? Knuckles?
Three and a half.
Rob's up to three and a half knuckles. Oh, brother. Stand by. Yeah. At some point, we'll give away Lisa's early pregnancy test.
Amen, brother.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hello.
Hi, you're on the air.
Hey, buddies. I've been trying to get through forever. You guys, great. And I also need to know when this trivia thing is going to start again.
Well, it's in danger right now, sir, of being canceled.
Uh-oh.
The evil Taliban forces
We've been here 3 or 4 times before where we come right down to the wire and we get the cold feet syndrome.
Mm-hmm.
But we will pull the plug.
We've decided that the bare bones we can go with is 4 girls and 4 guys.
Yeah, it has to be 4 or we will not do it.
Got to be 4.
And guys, you can help by sending us your wives, sisters, girlfriends. Let's roll.
Just right. Calling them, especially if you're close to the studios here in Fairfax, Virginia.
But that's you got to remember one thing, whoever's on the show. You got to make sure she has a great ass!
A great ass!
A great ass! And we got her head all the way up it!
Okay. All right, thank you, my friend.
All right,
friend.
Thanks.
I messed up with that bitch.
See you later. Because she got a great ass!
Yeah.
And you got your head all the way up it!
Jesus.
Ferocious, aren't I? When I think of asses, woman's ass, something comes out of me.
Hello, Don and Mike Show. Hello.
I'm Mike. I'm not trying to do a voice. It's Glenn the Janitor. How you doing?
Glenn, listen, you know what?
I have some serious stuff to say.
Now, Glenn, I want to tell you something. Yeah. I heard yesterday, I read on the instant feedback at NAW that I know that you're a radiophile, but were you in with Stern?
Yes.
With Stern yesterday?
Yes.
Okay, then you know what? Sorry.
What are you talking about? I've always made it quite honest to every show that I'm an individual for every different show.
No characters
are the same for any other show.
No. I don't mind sharing. I understand that you're the radiophile for WNEW.
No. I am radiophile. I've even been on the Sally Jesse show. I've been quite honest, fellas.
Sorry. Goodbye, Glenn.
I need a chance to defend myself.
No, you don't, Glenn.
You guys are really weird, man. That is so, like, afraid of a guy who's got some things to say. Well, anyway.
We're afraid of you.
Show goes today, this will be the last thing I ever say on your show, then.
Last thing you say on your show, okay. Let's give him the last thing he says on the show.
Go ahead, Glenn.
All right, your show's...
Well, too bad. There he goes.
Okay. Sorry, Glenn.
You know, I don't mind if the guy is a radiophile on all of the shows on NEW.
That's fine.
Or on all of the shows on JFK, you know.
But when it comes to other radio stations, we're territorial.
Right, correct.
Got to be like that.
Hello there, Don and Mike Show. We were flooded yesterday on the instant feedback saying that Glenn the janitor guy apparently, you know, that's how you got to learn your lesson in radio the hard way. And a lot of times that's how we learn. Hold on a second here. I'm about to make a very astute point that we learn our lesson the hard way, that we got warned as soon as we put that guy on our show.
Right.
We got calls from New York. We got the instant feedback saying this guy's trouble. Every other show has kicked him off.
Mm-hmm.
Don't put this guy on your show.
Yeah, and we base our level of punishment on how much we will miss the individual. So we really didn't want to waste any time with Glenn.
Right. I'm sorry for that delay. What can we do for you?
I'm calling in regards to Lisa's pregnancy test.
You want it?
No, why would anybody want it?
As a souvenir?
I mean, it's just pee-pee.
just pee-pee. But there's guys, I'm sure, that would like to sniff it.
And house readers.
Lick it. Put it in bad places.
Yeah. It does. It is kind of shaped like a thermometer.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Don and Mike, I will stay faithful to your show. I will never call another show. Don and Mike.
Yes, Mike Landis.
I love you guys.
Love you too. See you later.
You guys have a great weekend.
Bye-bye. See you later. Hold on now. Here's Rose calling us from the lobby. Is this Rose in the lobby?
Yes, it is.
Well, Rose...
Wait, no, this sounds like a guy.
No.
No,
it says she's in the lobby.
Okay, I'm Rose, totally paranoid.
If you're in the lobby, just come in the studio. Just have Colette bring you by.
Well, I think they're all out there.
How do I do that?
Are you really calling us from the lobby? Yeah, no, she is. Bring her in.
That's the echo in the lobby.
How many women do we have now?
I think she's it.
I'm the only one.
She's the only one.
Oh, you're the only one here?
All right, well, come on in. Come in. Whatever you want to think.
Okay.
Yeah, well, then we have to rescue her. Because you also have, if it's only one woman, you have that walkout potential.
Mm-hmm. It sounds like we're getting her subconscious. There's so much echo.
Yeah, there's so much echo there.
Inside the mind of Rose.
Well, that's because she's out in that cavernous lobby.
Oh, boy. And she's a looker, too.
Really?
Maybe she can talk to other women listening and talk them into coming back.
Well, that usually helps. We actually do that occasionally.
Well, bring her in. Here is Rose.
Bring Rose in here.
The only woman, incidentally, who is a man of her word.
Hi, Rose. American.
Mm.
How are you?
Great.
What a cutie, too.
A true woman of her word. Rose, pull up the microphone there. What would you say to the other women that are, are getting cold feet today?
Well, I don't want it to be canceled.
Mm-hmm.
They're screwing it up for everybody.
Yeah, that's true.
They sure are. Boy, I bet you look great naked.
See, this is the spotlight that women get on strip trivia.
Who is the celebrity that you told us you most resembled?
Cheryl Teagues.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, those bigger boobs, though.
Very nice.
Oh. Absolutely, because Cheryl Teagues got like those small mosquito bite things.
So was it awkward for you out there with all the guys hanging out?
No, we were having fun.
They were, all right, you're cool with that? You're down with that?
Sure.
Good. So what did you want to say?
I thought since nobody showed up and you were going to cancel that I could come in and strip down and get the key.
Oh, so it's totally mercenary.
Right,
it wasn't
get
about
us.
Get out of here, Rose.
Get out.
We're gonna hopefully start the game in a short time. Now
we'll see you later. Get out of here, Rose.
Right. Check back with you. Nice try, though.
When you're hot, but you're not that hot.
Yeah, very, very nice try.
Right.
She's cute.
Consider that offer in another 15 or 20 minutes.
She's got a very, very good personality, too. Seems to be really ready to play the game.
She's got a nice sweater. She really does.
All right, so we're still waiting.
Yes, mm-hmm. We're waiting. God damn it, we're waiting. And now the clock is running. Now we're down to 10 more minutes. And then we're, for the first time ever, we're canceling strip trivia.
Yes, absolutely.
I mean this. I really do.
Well, you gave us 25 about 7 minutes ago.
Well, all right, you're going to be a stickler about it?
I'm being a stickler because
all right, then 18 minutes to go.
18 minutes to go.
18 minutes to go. And then for the first time ever, it'll be a sad day on the history of the Don and Mike Show.
Wouldn't it?
We cancel strip trivia.
Yeah, that would be. That would really just ruin my weekend.
Well, let me just say something else. We cancel strip trivia now. We cancel it forever.
What?
Yes, that's right, Rob. That's right. That's how strongly I feel about this.
Wow.
Can't you tell how serious I am about this? Wow. We cancel it today. We never do this bit again.
What are you thinking?
We put this out on the open market.
What are you doing?
For any other disc jockey in America. You want this bit?
What the hell are you doing?
You're thinking with your heart.
It's run it.
It's Don, don't let this happen, man.
No, listen, the ladies are telling
us. For the love of God, don't threaten this.
You're losing your mind, fellas.
You got to listen to the audience. The audience is telling us that they've lost interest in strip trivia.
That's okay.
No.
That's okay.
Oh, my God.
That's okay. I've always gone with what the audience thinks.
Drive, women, drive.
You're sick of it?
This?
He said 11 o'clock. It's an hour late.
You're sick of it? That's okay.
God damn it.
That's okay. We'll move on. We got other stuff we can do. We got new bits we can run. Hello, Don and Mike show.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, you know, I've never even pulled out the porno football game.
Yeah.
Although we can't play that one today because that requires a bit of setup.
Mm-hmm.
But that's a great new one we got coming up.
Porno football.
Oh, and our Thanksgiving promotion. Aye, aye, aye. You're going to love that.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to love it involving defrosted turkeys. Hello, Bill.
Yes.
Hi, you're on the air, Bill.
Hey, man, can I go for Lisa's pregnancy test?
Can you what, Bill?
Could I try to win her pregnancy test?
Well, I'll give it to you if you want it.
Sure.
I'll just give it to you. Why do you want it?
I never won anything on the radio before. I never got into a show either, so.
Oh, okay.
So he got through, and this is the first thing you've won. Congratulations.
Hey, thank you. Made my day, guys.
All right,
love you guys.
Thank you. Would you like, now there were two that she used. There was the first one that she used at the beginning of the show, and the second one that she used towards the end of the show. Which of Lisa's pregnancy tests would you like?
Whatever you'd like to grace me with.
Nice, very open.
Give him
the first one.
All right, you get the first one.
Cool, thank you.
All right, Bill, where are you calling from?
Edison, New Jersey.
Beautiful. Hold on just a moment.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Great prize coming your way.
Hey, thank you.
Congratulations, you won one of Lisa's used early pregnancy tests.
A lucky man.
It's great for stirring coffee.
Yeah, fantastic. We still got a second one to go. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, I just want to say I just landed in Seattle from Sacramento, and I'm very happy to hear you guys live and on FM.
Yeah, we finally made that upgrade in Seattle to the Buzz 100.7 FM. It's beautiful.
Yeah, it didn't come on until an hour late. But.
Yeah, that's, you know, and that's the only caveat, that the good people of Seattle have got the call. You know, it's embarrassing that the morning show on the Buzz in Seattle
is
douchebags Mark and Brian. That our show, if they were to pick it up live in Seattle, starts at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Right?
Why not just run 2 hours of Dummy and Dummy, and then pick the show up at 8? Or if you want the same result, just sign off from 6 to 8 in the morning and start your broadcast day at 8 a.m. when
tap dead air.
When we come on, right.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, just run from 6 to 8 in the morning.
Like maybe some nice music in the background, you know, just generic elevator music.
No, just 2 hours of this.
Double dead air. Complete and
right,
double
just
dead air.
It's all done.
And then at 8 o'clock, KQBZ Seattle now begins its broadcast day.
It's 8 o'clock. Ready for fun, kids?
Yeah. Please call the station and tell them it's great that we're on FM in Seattle. We love it, but you got to get the fourth hour.
All right.
If I'm going to work on anyone, I'm going to work on Sacramento.
Yeah. Well, yeah, they got to run the show live, too, for God's sakes, because I know the people of Sacramento are hating us now at the show.
Well, I'm happy to be here because I just got in from Sacramento.
And, you know, we hate the fact that the show is on tape delay in so many cities that really, honestly, we love, like Sacramento and Baltimore. All the cities really that gave us the great ratings and allowed us to get syndicated. Wichita is another one. And, you know, I'm sorry, it's a fact that the show's time has changed.
Right.
Can you tell us what the turkey thing is?
No, but you'll hear it very soon. And all I can say is to all of the people who have listened and supported this show over the years in these markets, we're sorry. We had to make the move on the time slot.
Had to do it.
We had to do it. It's best for our careers. But your radio stations certainly can make the move with us.
Mm-hmm.
And we've put in the deal that they don't have to re-up. Like the station in Seattle, when they sign up, okay, you know what? That's not one of the freebie jeebies. Like the way we used to do it was a barter deal, meaning that if a station signed up for our show,
right,
they wouldn't have to pay. They would just have to run Westwood One commercials, and that's how Mike and I would get paid.
Barter.
Well, the new deal now is that so we get stations that were positive are behind the show, it's strictly a cash deal, right?
And it also makes for a better relationship with the station.
Right, because, that you know, if they're really paying you out of their pocket, they're not going to get the show and 30 days later decide, guess what, we hate it, we're going to cancel it.
Yeah, it's cash and also a little barter.
Yeah, so, but what we decided was, for the stations that were already on the deal, well, we're not going to screw them around.
No, absolutely not. They've been with us all along.
They can stay with the same plan. They don't have to pay the outrageous cost of this show now.
Oh, that's great.
But all we ask in return is that, hey, how about shifting your broadcast schedule so you can carry the show live?
Yeah, this show, as we have proven, works best live, and I really hope that a lot of those markets can come around on that. So everybody would
certainly
win.
Understand what they're dealing with, but we really want them to come around and broadcast us live. All right, but anyway, it's great to be back in Seattle. If only we could get that fourth hour. Thank you, my friend.
Thank you.
Thank you. See you later. Hello, Andy. Don and Mike show. Hello.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Yeah, how callous is it for CBS and NBC to run irregular programming last night instead of President? Survivor is that important?
I want to tell you, I was blown away last night when I got home and I saw that Friends was on. Mm-hmm. And I thought, what the heck could this? I just listened to the president on the radio.
It's pretty nuts.
And I guess that of the four, Fox, NBC, ABC, and CBS, only ABC ran the president.
Right.
And they ran the president because they normally get killed in that time slot anyway.
Yeah, it was amazing to me that they did that. I you know, this was really supposed to be one of the most significant talks that he's given since the disaster.
That's what the White House said publicly, but the White House never made its usual formal request to the network for airtime. There was no formal request, so nobody really had to do it at all. Even ABC didn't have to do it.
But should they have to? I mean, we're coming off a time where the whole government mindset is we should be supportive and be patient and really, you know, keep our nose in this and make sure this happens. I don't think they should have had to ask anything. It's sort of ludicrous,
well,
really.
I'm just glad it didn't F up Temptation Island.
Me too.
which listen, I'm burned out on Survivor. I'm not burned out
on Temptation Island.
I don't watch Survivor, but Temptation Island.
You like the one girl that was with all the guys last night?
I sure do.
You know the one I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Where they carried her like Cleopatra?
You know who my favorite is on Temptation Island? It's the girl. She's one of the four who watched the videotape of her boyfriend.
Right.
The girl in the blue top.
Yes.
She got huge, massive, titanic orbs. She's so cute.
And they've got a Billy Cleary on there this year, too.
They sure do.
They've got another guy with the leather necklace.
Yeah.
The idiot boy.
Yeah, Temptation Island is as good in the second year as it was in the first.
Oh, absolutely.
As good. When they're showing the videotapes, and these poor broads are having to watch the girls who are on the dates with their boyfriends, like one of them, we got a break. I love it. One of them says, well, really, I think what Billy wants is a woman who's less controlling. He wants a woman. And in essence, what she's saying is that Billy, whoever this guy is, he wants a woman who will kowtow and do whatever he wants. And his girlfriend, his real girlfriend, she thinks too much for herself. it was fantastic.
You got some damn dummies on that show.
They got some hot girls on that show, too.
Yeah, a lot of low IQs and hot-looking people.
Yeah, Temptation Island, that's a winner.
It is.
Temptation Island.
It's a great formula, and, you know, they've tweaked it up.
Yeah.
They've gotten better-looking people.
Yeah, and I think there's going to be a lot of sex this year. Of course, you're not going to see it because it's regular TV.
Why not?
But I think there's going to be some banging.
Oh, absolutely. And that one girl.
I know what you mean. Yeah, right.
Sure. More bikinis.
She's got it.
I mean, there are a couple of them. The one under the waterfall.
Nice. You know who else is nice? The one with the red top.
Oh, yes.
Again, in the four, the one who had like the pigtail happening. Mm-hmm. She had kind of a Pocahontas look to her.
Yeah. I like that show. That show doesn't need to do anything. It doesn't have to have any plot.
It could get rid of that queer host, though. I mean, I don't hate him as much as Jeff Probst.
Well, he's a Jeff Probst wannabe. Right?
No, he is what he is.
Yep.
Although I give him credit when the girls are watching the videotape and they're seeing their boyfriends like making out with other girls and the one guy who was he had a hose and he was just on his date. He was not that hose. It was a garden hose. He was just hosing down this girl and she's watching it and she's starting to cry. And they cut to the host who's sitting there, and he's smiling at her.
Loving the moment.
He's smiling like, yeah.
So what do you think?
Yeah, it's great. Very good television. So, yes, I guess in essence, I'm all for President Bush being on TV whenever he wants
right.
to, as long as it's not when something good like Temptation Island is on.
Yeah, he ought to have the Temptation Island writer on it.
Absolutely. Let's break. We're almost up to decision time with Strip Trivia now.
We don't have an update.
How much time you got left, Mike? Are you keeping track?
Yeah, you get. Well, we're going to know when we come back from the commercial break. We will know whether it's going to happen or not.
All right. Don't make us send us to your room. That thing, go to your room without dinner.
It will be a real drag.
We'll be right back, maybe to make history on this show.
Oh, my God.
With the final Strip Trivia canceled.
No. Oh, no.
Done forever.
No.
We'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Yes, company.
Get out of here, Curtis. I don't hear you unless you knock.
You can call Don and Mike anytime, toll-free at 1-877-365-3636. That's 1-877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you.
Damn right.
Booyah!
Yeah, that's the national number.
Right.
877-365-3636. Washington, D.C., your hotline, 202-432-1067.
World champion chicken brickers, Don and Mike.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. I was put on hold. I was wanting to come down to the Strip Trivia thing. I didn't know if you guys were still doing it.
Where are you at?
Silver Spring.
Silver Spring?
No.
Not a chance, honey. Sorry. Thank you, though.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Yeah.
Right.
BS.
Rob is counting his knuckles. I'll tell you what, this is it. We're down to it. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Don, Mike.
Yeah.
Hey, it's James. I played Strip Trivia with you in September last time you played it. For all women from anywhere in Fairfax, please come down. Do not let this happen.
Well, we don't even know what the status is yet.
Let's find out. Lisa, would you please bring all of the contestants into the studio? We will find out live right now along with you.
Good. Right now.
If there will be any more Strip Trivia ever on the show.
Oh, very good.
And this is embarrassing that we solicit for a bit and we have all these girls call up. I still see just the same girl.
Well, why are we bringing the guys in?
Well, because I want to dismiss the jury.
Oh, okay. All right. Very good.
Just dismiss them all right now. Tell them all thanks for coming in.
This is a total breakdown.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the passing of a great bit.
Yeah, it was wonderful when we used to do it. The gentlemen are all very, very disappointed, but we have standards.
Sorry. One at a time, step up and tell us your names, please. And you are?
I'm Rose.
Rose, I remember Rose. Hi, Rose.
I called some friends, but they couldn't make it.
Well, what, Rose?
I called some friends, but they couldn't make it.
Yeah.
I hate funerals. Funerals are so sad.
They're very depressing, aren't they?
So sad.
And you, sir, what's your name?
It's Kevin.
Kevin.
Can we pay Rose to take her top off?
You can pay Rose.
Yeah, but you'll have to do that on your own.
To take her top off. Who else is here? Well, what's your name, sir?
How you doing? I'm Jason.
Hi, Jason. Thanks for not letting us down.
Yeah, we appreciate it. Even though the guys, you know, it's always an automatic, we still appreciate the guys showing up.
We can't do a homo version, though. And what's your name, sir?
I'm Miles.
Miles?
Yep.
Sorry, Miles.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate. Yeah.
And you are? Step up, please.
I'm Eric.
And who?
Eric.
Hi, Eric. Sorry about this. And you, sir, step up. What's your name?
Pete.
Oh, Pete. Look at this.
Fine strapping dudes today. The ladies would have enjoyed them.
They sure would have.
What we wanted to do is get some poster board and markers and go out on the street and solicit. Or attempt.
No, we have our standards here. We have never had this happen before.
We want to play. We came to play.
We understand
that. And I know that, and we appreciate that you guys and girl came to play.
Now, I am curious about these alleged people that Lisa has spoken to that allegedly were in traffic. What is your take on it, Lisa?
Honey, what's the deal on that?
They're lying.
What do you think? What?
Are they lying?
Yeah.
You think they're lying to you?
Yes.
Probably.
And so they've been lying to you all along.
Yeah. Oh, now, look at that.
And she's just coming off her binge, so she's sensitive to start with.
She doesn't need this. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a sad day in the history of the Don and Mike Show.
That's right.
Because really, look what time it is now. We've only got like 2 hours and 10 minutes, 50 minutes left of the show.
It's just a real tragedy.
Listen, any other radio show out there that wants Strip Trivia, it was a great bit that worked for years for us.
Take it with our compliments.
It's ours.
That's right.
Girl. That's all I can say. We're gonna have to give the key away and the trip away.
Yep.
To well, you know, I don't want to slight this group here.
No.
I think that this group, one of you, can certainly win the trip. to North Carolina.
Put all their names in a hat and have them pull it out.
Yeah. Maybe just have whoever take her top off. Do you want the trip? I'll give you the trip. You take your clothes off.
Yeah.
Rose?
Yeah. Hey, she's a trooper. Isn't that a little fun?
Rose is hot.
Yes, she is. And all the guys are in here just staring. It's wonderful.
Yeah,
it's
wow.
Very, very nice.
If the guys could just, you know, step aside.
Damn, I'm going to...
Yeah, guys, you got to clear Buzz's window.
I'm really going to miss strip trivia.
I'm going to miss it, too.
Right here?
I'll sit
right
there.
Right around here? Yes. Yeah,
so. I am really going to miss strip trivia.
Hey, wait, Lisa. No, Lisa, what are you doing?
No, wrong.
No. This is not for Buzz. No. Buzz has his window. That's it. Absolutely. Buzz, if you'd like to come around.
Okay.
Get off your ass.
Come in here, Buzz.
Jesus Christ.
Well, thanks for the invitation.
God damn. Lisa, like, puts her right in front of Buzz's
window. Stand in front of Buzz's window.
I'm just trying to help.
Oh, let the old man come in on his own. Someone get him his walker and bring him in.
Very good.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
Sorry, it's a little testy in here today.
All right, Rose, we're ready.
We're playing the music.
Everything?
Oh, everything.
Everything, yeah, absolutely.
Everything.
All right, she's taking your shoes off.
Now, guys,
we're taking some of the pain away.
We're not exaggerating. I mean, Rose is hot, isn't she, guys?
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, no, Rose is beautiful.
Taking her clothing off, which is really softening the blow of losing.
So to speak.
Trivia.
Look at the black underpants.
Yes, very matching underwear. Just very, very nice. Absolutely
look at
terrific.
What an exhibitionist
yes,
she is.
Exhibitionist.
I'm going to miss strip trivia. Here comes the bra.
You're about to hear a big round of applause as the top comes off.
Wow.
Very nice. Yes, sirree.
Oh, nice.
Absolutely. And now the bottoms come off.
Look at that. Wow.
Thank you, Rose.
Wow.
Thank you. Oh, and she's getting a tip. She's getting a tip from Mother. I think, are you Kevin?
No.
What's your name, Kevin?
Yeah.
Kevin, the horniest man in the room. There's no question about. Kevin Rose, had that billboard idea.
Rose, you are beautiful. You are naked. And you have won the a trip to Greensboro, North Carolina to see the WWF Survivor Series, courtesy of Comcast and Cox Cable, in demand Sunday, November 18th. Everybody call Comcast and Cox Cable to order this pay-per-view event.
How sad. It's not sad that Rose got naked, but how sad, you know, that it had to happen this way.
And for the guys, all the guys will get the pay-per-view, okay, of the WWF Survivor. I'm sorry, guys. Sorry about that. But you did get to see Rose naked.
Yeah, I mean, there was some payoff. It was worth coming down here.
And Rose is the major POA.
Incredible.
That's right.
She is indeed.
Sorry about that. And sorry to say that we're never doing it again.
No, can't.
Someone can call that that guy that likes copying our show on DC-101 and tell him he can have the bit.
He can have it.
Take it.
Be terrific for him.
I mean, the guy likes taking whatever show we do and doing it 2 or 3 days later.
He can have our scraps. He can have it.
I make that to any disc jockey in any of the markets that we broadcast to.
Take it. Take strip trivia.
You've heard it for years. You've thought, wow, how can people really come down and take their clothes off?
Don, I'd like to pledge, though, that there will continue to be nudity on this program.
Yes, just not in the form of strip trivia.
That is correct.
Can he also have Dick Stockton?
Sure.
Yeah. Yeah, you can have Dick Stockton as a guest as well.
You can have Dick Stockton naked.
See, everybody thought that we weren't serious about it.
No, we're serious. Now, enough of the games, you know. Obviously, our staff suffered from game playing on the part of these women.
Serious as cancer.
I'd like to know who those women were, too.
Don't worry, Mike. We got Knuckles on it.
Yeah, good.
Ain't that right, Knuckles?
4¾.
There you
go. 4¾.
Fantastic.
All right, well, a round of applause to all of you who did show up.
Thank you, folks.
Thank you. It's a sad day for the Don and Mike show.
Very, very depressing day for us today.
Sad day, but a great day for Rose.
Absolutely.
All right, get out of here.
Thanks. Get out of here, guys.
Sorry.
Thank you all very much.
So sorry.
Take care, everybody.
Bye, Rose.
Hanging heads.
They're just people.
Just people.
Well, Rose, hold on. You get back on the microphone. What, honey? We can't hear you.
On the microphone,
please.
I can hear you.
The word Washington does not have an R in it.
I never say Washington.
Okay. Busting Buzz's balls.
I always say Washington. In fact, I pick on people who say Washington.
That's right. Bye-bye. All right. Bye, Rose.
It made it a little more special, didn't it, Buzz?
Yes,
how
it
about
did.
That, Rose? Finally, someone who doesn't like you.
Wow, Rose with a capital C. She's fun.
There we go.
She's hot. Man, what a body on her.
And to hell with all those other ladies that said they were.
Yeah. Good. Well, those of you who I know people have like MP3s and tapes of the old show and the WAV files and all that stuff.
Right.
That's the only way you're going to hear strip trivia from now on.
Yeah, and enjoy it from the archives.
We're officially throwing it out there. I know that there have been stations. We get reports like there's a station in Miami that's doing it, and that there's a station in California, in Los Angeles, that's doing it.
Right. Absolutely.
We've let it go under the radar, but now we're just telling all the disc jockeys in America, take it.
Sure.
We're never doing it again.
Stay tuned for Strip Price is Right.
But no more strip trivia.
No.
Strip
no
trivia is strip dead. Trivia.
Dead
strip
to us.
Trivia is gone. Dead bit walking. There it goes.
Right.
Are you listening, DC 101? Go ahead. Take it. Take it with my best wishes.
Stay tuned for Stripper Theater.
We'll find a way to make it happen. Yeah.
Maybe some pros, Doug.
Nudity will be a part of the show.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know.
Maybe some reliable women who can guarantee quality nudity.
Maybe.
None of this amateur crap.
Maybe that's the level we move to.
Yeah.
Where now we just have to have professional strippers and hoes.
Strip tattletales.
Strip card sharks.
Yeah. And we can make it happen.
Yeah, we're not going to let you down.
No.
No. Okay. All right. Well, that's how it happens.
We've worked with amateurs for years.
We've got to be honest with our audience. Listen, the girls weren't there to support the bit today.
That is correct.
So we can't do it. I'm sorry. Hold on. Sharon is on the line. Sharon.
Yes?
Oh, this is the girl who said she would be here 2 hours ago from New York.
Yes.
Yeah. What?
I'm 10 minutes away, and I can't believe you're doing this.
Well, what the hell are we supposed to do? We got a four-hour show.
No, I didn't expect 3 traffic accidents, and, you know, what can you...
Oh, now is she crying?
Pretty close.
No, she's busting balls. You can come, you still come on and get naked. We'll give you a great prize.
No. I can get naked with somebody I like.
Oh, wow.
And so can we.
Hey, the compliments just keep flying.
Where are you really?
I'm 10 minutes away.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
You said that the last time you spoke with Lisa.
No, I told her I was an hour away.
Where are you specifically?
I'm in a Marriott hotel making this phone call. I could be driving.
In a Marriott hotel where?
With just right outside of Fairfax.
Where?
So she gave me the directions, and I have them, and I'm...
Yes, but,
sounds like she's 60 years old.
But you don't like us.
I love you.
No, I thought, well, you didn't. You, I just said you can come down and get naked for a prize. You said, well, I want to do that for people I like.
Well, I wanted to participate in the...
In the game?
In the game.
Who is the celebrity you said you most resemble?
Linda Carter.
Linda Carter.
Well, listen, if you want to come by, come on by. We'd be glad to give you a great prize for taking your clothes off.
Linda or Roslyn? I didn't hear.
Roslyn Carter. Or Amy. Amy Carter. Well, listen, Sharon, come on by, and let's see what you got. We'd love to still give you a prize. But you got to understand that, really, it was 2 hours ago that we were supposed to start.
Yeah, I mean, really, frankly, we're...
I only got up at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, maybe 4 o'clock would have been better.
I think I should have.
Well, listen, come on by anyway.
All right.
Okay, Sharon.
Thank you.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, we'll see her in a minute.
No, we won't.
You don't think she's showing?
No, I guarantee she's not showing.
Hello, Don and Mike show.
Don, Mike, yeah. Buzzy.
Hi there.
Hey, Don.
Yes.
I think Frida's probably going to be very excited that this has taken place today. I don't think she cared for strip trivia too much.
But don't worry. There will be another game that will take its place.
Yeah, man.
Well, I think you're at least going to have one good weekend with your wife.
Yeah, and I think that probably what Mike said is true, that in the future we'll call the Gold Club, we'll call, you know, down to Good Guys, to Camelot.
And we'll give strippers a chance to do something they normally don't do. You know, not the standard thing where you ask them, like, newsmaker questions, but give them something that, you know, that might be unusual for strippers to do.
Okay, more naked chicks. Well, thanks, guys.
All right, yeah, no, we'll make it happen. Thank you, my friend.
I'm having a good idea.
What's that?
Stripper on stripper, strip pyramid. Where they would have to describe the clues. I know the home game exists.
Was that right. Like the $20,000 pyramid?
It would be pretty
very
strong.
Difficult to translate on the radio, though.
Hello,
no, I don't think so. It's very oral.
Hold on, Crazy Debbie's on the line. Hi, Crazy
Will.
Hi, Crazy Debbie.
How are you?
We're doing great, thanks.
Good. You know what? I got my husband here. You got to talk to my husband because I tell him all the time how I call you guys.
Oh.
Like, you think I'm nuts. And you think my husband's an alcoholic.
God. Okay, I put him on, Crazy
Hold
Debbie.
Hold on. His name is Jim. Hold on.
Jim Beam. Here he is.
His name was Jim.
Here he is. Oh. The late Jim. Jim.
Yeah, how you doing?
Are you really married to this broad?
It's unbelievable, man.
She drives us crazy when she calls our show.
Yeah, well, better you than me, my friend.
This guy cracks me up.
How long have you been married to Crazy Debbie?
10 years.
Ten?
Oh, the long-suffering Jim.
10 years. Guys do less time for murder.
Jim, how do you compensate? How do you deal with it?
I work a lot.
All right, Jim. Well, thanks for calling, and good luck with that wife of yours. God, you got a mouth on her.
Thank you very much.
All right, put her
good
back.
Good luck, guys. Good luck to you guys.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, what, with your wife calling us every day?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's speak to the lovely woman again.
Hold on.
You want to talk to me again?
Yeah. Well, Crazy Debbie,
I just had to call you. I wanted you to talk to my husband. I finally wasn't out of range that I would get cut off.
You know, I'm just wondering how much every month in cotton balls they must
yeah,
for this guy's poor ears.
Very sad.
Jesus Christ.
Just people.
All right, thanks, Crazy Debbie.
Okay, dudes. Love you guys.
Love you.
Talk to you later.
All right,
goodbye.
Bye-bye. Bye. Bye, Debbie. She is Crazy Debbie. I can think of nobody better to call on such a sad, sad day for the Don and Mike Show. The day that we bid adieu to strip trivia.
Mm-hmm.
Well, but the good news is that means that key, that Mercedes key,
mm-hmm,
somebody who's actually listening to the show today and has listened to the whole show is going to win that key.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Hold on, what is this? Dave. Hey, Don and Mike Show. Hi, Dave.
Yeah, I got an idea for you. Instead of, you know, strip trivia, why don't you have a joke off for that key?
Oh, no.
No, there's only so much we can take during one day.
No, please. We did make us laugh about a month ago.
Yeah.
We're still recovering from that.
That'll be suicidal. We'll be up on top of the building if we did that today.
All right, thank you, my friend.
All right, hail to the skin.
Right. Amen. Amen. Okay, we got a break. We're going to figure out how we're going to give away this key. Call your local disc jockeys across America and tell them strip trivia is officially out there.
There you go.
It's out there. Take it. And from now on, that's it. All pros, all the time.
And wouldn't it be safe to say you can look for pros on this show relatively soon?
How about Monday? We will make this up to our listeners.
Absolutely.
We will have pros in here. I don't care if it's a $25,000 pyramid, if
right,
it's concentration, if it's Wheel of Fortune.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have naked chicks in here playing a game.
Wheel of Fortune.
Oh. Maybe we'll play Wheel of Fortune with strippers.
There you go.
On Monday.
Very
we'll
good.
Be right back.
And Mike Show.
Toss my salad, that's it, we're straight.
Providing at least one chub a day. Guaranteed. The Don and Mike Show.
All right, we're doing some thinking. Here's the dealio. Strip trivia as we knew it is dead.
Yes.
That's it. I'm tired of setting up the game and like a million girls call and
right,
then we always got a beg at the very end.
Yeah.
So, really, we're thinking about all the games out there.
Mm-hmm.
The Wheel of Fortunes, Jeopardy, Trivial Pursuit. But this $20,000 pyramid game, now picture this. I want to do this on Monday. What a chance for someone in our listening audience to win a key for the Mercedes. Say we do it like this. Let's say that, first off, we got to have a guy who owns one of the strip clubs in the D.C. area
mm-hmm,
be listening and give us a call at 877-365-3636 and 202-432-1067.
Mm-hmm.
Got to be some enterprising guy that owns a strip club, Camelot, the Gold Club, whatever it is, Nexus, to send down five or six of his finest girls to be on Monday's episode.
Right.
Okay, then each girl will play for a random caller. We'll ask, like, for mm-hmm, caller number 100. And the girls will play the $20,000 pyramid. They'll take their clothes off for every question that they get wrong.
Okay.
And because of the profession that they're in,
mm-hmm,
and because most of them generally are not high school, college graduates.
Right.
There'd be a real good chance that we could have some real fun.
Absolutely.
And so here's how we're picturing it. Buzz, who's in the next studio, mm-hmm, we can turn all the monitors in here off.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say that we've got two strippers in here.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Buzz says,
the category is things you don't want to put up your nose.
Right. Or whatever it is.
Right.
So everybody listening would know what the category is.
That's right.
And then you would hear the two girls trying to get it. right?
Sure.
And then the girl who's left at the and if they get it wrong, the girls have to take an article of clothing off.
Mm-hmm.
The girls who are left, there would be two left, then they would battle each other, one-on-one battle royale. The one girl who's left with the clothes on, she would win the key for the guy who's listening to the show.
All right.
And since they're strippers, we'd know that they'd have no problem coming in here and when they get a question wrong, taking their clothes off.
Absolutely.
And we'd have some hot POA to put on the DonandMikeFans.com website.
Absolutely. Yeah. It'll be fantastic.
So we need an escort service would do.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you think they should be naked the whole time?
Sure.
You think they should just be naked chicks?
Two teams of two naked chicks.
Yeah, because
chicks
it has no bearing on the game because they're playing for a caller.
Right, and each team would represent a caller, and they could actually hear, the way they do it on Pyramid, they'd hear the name of the category. Buzz would just say the clue each time.
Mm-hmm.
He would whisper it, like as they got it, either buzzed or dinged.
Oh, I got. Oh, right, because they show the category.
They're like, we'll draw up a big board for them to choose from.
Things you don't want to pick from your nose.
Excellent. Right.
Okay, gotcha.
And they're playing against the other stripper, or are they playing with the caller?
Each team will be representing a caller.
And playing against
each other. They're opposing, and they'll have, I think it's 30 seconds to get 7 clues. I'll have to watch Game Show Network this
week. Then we need a total of 12 girls.
12 girls.
Because if we had, then they'd be able to play for 6 listeners.
Yes.
All kinds of sudden death going on.
Wouldn't that be great?
Yeah. 12 strippers in here.
Wow. So, you know what we got to do? We got to get a strip club owner, or maybe someone from an escort service to give us a call and supply us with 12 naked girls to play the naked pyramid on Monday.
That'd be great. Very good.
And then each of the teams will play for one of our listeners who can call in at random on Monday's show.
Excellent.
So we'll still have the naked chicks.
And remember, there's still a lucky 7-Eleven behind one of those categories on the board.
That'd be a good deal. Hello, Dan.
Hey.
Hey.
What's up?
Hey, hi.
I just wanted to talk to you regarding the cancellation of strip trivia. I think it's good that you're replacing with this naked pyramid thing.
Yeah.
But about those other guys who copy your bits, they really suck. I mean, you guys are funny.
Well, thank you. Thank you, my
very
friend.
Very kind of you to say thank you for your kind words.
Thank you.
I'm upset that they moved you to middays. I know it's for your careers and all.
Yeah.
But now I don't really get to listen to you that much.
Well, here, you're listening today and you're calling today. It's a great day.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Except not early of work.
Except it's a sad day because it's the
day
last
morning.
The last day ever that the mention of strip trivia. Oh, hold on. Listen, I got to go. I got a guy who owns a strip club on the line.
Ah, sure.
That's fast.
I just wanted to tell you guys are awesome.
Thank you, my friend.
Okay.
Thank
you. Have a nice day.
Very and nice. Here we go. Hello?
Hello? hello?
No, I was too busy trying to figure out $25,000. Well, there he is. It's Tom Gavin.
And beside him.
Patriotic Tom Gavin.
I got Tom.
Is that it, Mike?
Tom, I got to go. Hey, what happened? Right. What happened to Leah? She was just
oh no.
Oh, TV star Leah Remini.
Leah was on the line?
Just on the line. She was just on line number 9. Line number 9.
Yard line.
Hello, Don and Mike show. Hello?
Speak to us.
Hi, Ben.
What's that?
Hey, hi, you're on the air, Ben.
Yeah, I wanted to tell you guys, I love this idea of strip pyramid.
Right.
I was thinking, since we're using these strippers, and, you know, they are of some fame, I'm thinking Strip Hollywood Squares might be a good idea.
Now, that's another one that we can consider at some point. Uh-huh. But to do that, we'd have to, like, really build a set for them.
Strip squares.
You don't need a set. You could have, I guess you'd have to have mental visuals.
No, but yeah, we'd have to have.
Might be tricky.
We'd have to build some kind of a set.
Right.
I mean, we'd have to.
With ladders and everything like that. Like the one that we saw when we were out there.
What if they just got piggybacked?
Just stood on each gun on each other's shoulder.
Or hands and knees.
Hello there, Johnny, Don and Mike show. Hello.
Hey, Don and Mike, how you doing, man?
Hi, Johnny, we're doing okay.
Hey, I'm calling from Rose Lounge, John. I understand you're looking for some bitches. About 12 of them.
Yes,
you about call them Jones?
Yes, we sure do.
I could probably hook you up now.
Yeah, I doubt it.
You need some girls?
No, come on now.
Huh?
Only legit guys, Johnny.
Now, come on now.
Now, Johnny,
I got some good-looking ones. I got some real good-looking ones.
I'll get out of here, Johnny.
Now, a couple of them might be pregnant.
Okay. That's always the case, though.
Get out of here. Yeah, we're putting the word out that we're looking for. But is this the theme to the $25,000 pyramid?
You want to do the pyramid, though.
Yeah, I like this game.
All All right, strip pyramid. Listen, we're putting the word out. We need a, and you know, as a matter of fact, hey, Rummy.
Come here, let me get Leah on the phone.
Hi, Leah.
Hi, babe.
Hi, hold on 1 second. Let me just.
Okay.
Hey, Rummy. Rummy, come here, please. Come on.
I'm here.
Rummy, hi. Listen, hi. Urgent. Call all of, I'm going to tell you in code.
Right. Okay.
Call her. Call some of the other strip clubs. We got to have
12 whores.
12
I mean,
pros.
Pros.
12
That's
pros.
That's not the right attitude. Pros.
Pros.
Pros. 12 pros special. Here on Monday.
You got it.
Okay, thank you. And now let's welcome to the show.
Our next guest is one of the stars of the popular television program, The King of Queens. Monday nights at 8 right here on CBS. Here's the lovely Leah Remini, ladies and gentlemen.
There she is, everybody, the lovely Leah. Leah, did you get my pager thing?
I didn't.
Oh, I paged you yesterday. I thought I paged you back that you were going to be, I thought it was Monday.
I'm confused.
Okay.
I'm very sorry. And then I just got a call from Charlie saying that you wanted me to come on Monday. But, you know, you have a very important striptease game happening Monday.
Yeah, well, we had to do some last-minute adjusting because one of our regular bits, strip trivia, didn't go as well as we had anticipated today.
But we're going to start a new one on Monday where we have pros down here. We're going to play strip pyramid, you know, $20,000 pyramid with strippers.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that today didn't go swimmingly.
No, it did not, Leah.
It did not go swimmingly at all, Leah.
It was a sad day, but the day is brightened by your call.
And we have to give you our undying thanks.
That's right.
That's right, buddy boy.
You
That's
are a right. woman of your word.
That's right.
Right.
You got up there with old horse-faced Joan Rivers, even after she called you Leon Lemony.
Yeah, and even though, you know, you were trying a couple of times to get that mention in there, and that fossil, that dinosaur, didn't let you do it. It was great. You
know
still
what?
Got it in there.
First of all, how did I look?
You looked awesome.
Of course, you're gorgeous.
Okay.
And we like the butt shot, too.
You like the ass,
Oh, big time.
Yeah.
The ass, though?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, I'm looking at her, and I'm thinking, no, she's going to come at me. You know what I mean?
And listen, anybody who doesn't...
Not only does she not come after me, but I don't even know if she's talking to me at a certain point.
Leah, you know, everybody, of course, Leah's the star of The King of Queens.
She was a presenter at the Emmy Awards.
On CBS, and she was on with the horse face.
With fossilized Joan Rivers.
Joan Rivers, and we said to Leah, would you please say hi to us when you're interviewed on Jurassic Park there, when Joan Rivers is going to interview you on the red carpet. And
right.
And God bless her, Leah did finally manage to get in hi to Don and Mike.
She did it.
But horse face would not let her get a word in edgeways. And I thought the funniest part was Leah said, hey, I want two of your big fans are Don and Mike.
That was great.
We hate Joan Rivers.
And Joan goes, oh, that's very nice.
Yeah. And Leah, I wanted to ask you this when I was watching that. First of all, thanks again for doing that. And is she as incredibly distracted as she appears to be on camera?
Well, that's what I'm saying. I came up there ready, guns a-blazing, ready for her to abuse me.
Right.
I didn't know if she was looking at me or looking at somebody else. I didn't know if she was talking to me or somebody else. And I don't know if you saw this, but I was kind of looking around, but from the side of me.
Right.
Thinking, is she talking to somebody else? I mean, it was so odd. Then I'm on the set the next day, and I'm reading an article. I'm just sitting on the set reading an article, and Joan and Melissa were being interviewed by this magazine, and they said, how are you going to be different this year? And it said, we're going to really tone it down this year. We're not going to abuse people. You know, we're just going to be very normal. I wish I had read that before I went up there because I looked like a lunatic.
Yeah, you didn't. You didn't look like a lunatic. I could tell that you were in the defensive crouch when you got up there. You were ready to do battle with Joan.
And why not?
Right, but what you didn't know is I had paged my publicist on my little two-way pager. She was on the red carpet when I was in the car. And I said, listen, I want to talk to Joan about something for my friends, Don and Mike, and I went through the whole thing, and I said, so just make sure that she leaves time for that, because I want to bring that up.
Well, that's
so
nice.
So my publicist paged me back, and she says, Joan's people said no, that she just wants to talk to you about other things.
Oh, what a
bitch. So I went up there knowing that they said no.
Oh, wow. I didn't even know. That's fantastic.
All right, well,
and I did it anyway.
You did. You are the man. Let's replay this. Now, listen to the beginning of this. First, okay. You know, old fossil face.
She's such a pain in the ass to watch.
She calls Leah. She does it. She says, "Who is it, Leon Lemony?"
Yeah, it's just so clueless. I mean, no need to do any real research.
That part.
Dumb bitch.
Well, you'll hear it now. We have it on tape.
And then listen, because Leah tries to work it in right away. She wants to say hi to us. But Joan Rivers will not give her a second. Here it is from the Emmy Awards last Sunday night.
And over here is Leon. Here we go. Leon Lemony. Here we go. Leon Lemony. Hi.
Hold on. You hadn't heard that before?
Oh, I'm horrified right now.
Leon Lemony.
I am horrified.
Yep.
Go ahead.
Leon Lemony. Okay, here we go.
And over here is Leon. Here we go. Leon Lemony. Here we go. Leah Remini.
Hi.
Look at you.
Yeah, what do you have?
You are presenter tonight.
Say it now.
You
say it now.
Leah Remini, a presenter.
What do you say? Say it now.
Not for the office.
What?
This is a very beautiful dress. This is not office. Don't get so crazy. Did you pay for it?
No, of course not.
Well, you can.
No, I care what you think, though.
Well, I think you look wonderful.
Okay, good. Thank you.
Now, would you care if somebody didn't like what you're wearing? You know you look great. Why would it bother you?
Pause it right there. Now, Leah, it was at that point that I thought you were going to try to work in the hi to us.
Right. I mean, I was so lost at this point because I didn't know. I knew something went wrong when I first got there, but I didn't know what went wrong. You know what I mean? You know when you're kind of like out of your body for a second, you can't hear?
Well,
I didn't know what she was saying, but I know something went wrong, and the fact that she wasn't even looking at me, I thought maybe that was it. You know,
she doesn't do, it's so obvious to me, I mean, that she does not do any preparation for those interviews. You could plug anyone into all of her interviews, and it wouldn't matter what celebrity was up there.
Okay, let's
roll. But now I'm hearing it, and I'm thinking, I sound really retarded. It's like,
no, you don't. You didn't sound retarded at all. Not at all.
I say that it doesn't bother me, but it does bother me. You know, out loud I go, who cares? Look at you. You look like an idiot, you know, but not you, meaning
yeah,
you.
I know what you're saying, yeah.
But if you did abuse me, then I'd have to abuse
Has
you.
Has anybody ever, did you ever wear anything? I wore something once, and every time I see it, I look like a big pink mushroom. I still want to kill myself.
Hold on,
did you ever
I want to stop it right there. Because if you listen to that, Leah says to Joan, because if you abuse me, then I'd have to abuse you, which is a funny line, which Joan just completely marches over,
barrels through,
and you don't get any appreciation for it. I mean, it's
just listening.
I know.
Right.
And it was very uncomfortable. Here I am coming at her like a lunatic, like she's like my enemy,
mm-hmm.
And I've never met her before, and they requested for me to be on their show, the first Emmy. They wanted me to come on and do a little commentary with, you know, who was coming down the red carpet. And so it's like, it's not like she didn't know me. I mean, they requested for me to be there.
Oh,
and then it's weird that she's like, she sounds like a normal, nice woman, and I sound like a lunatic.
No, you don't know. She said, well, come on, she called you Leon Lemony. She's an idiot.
Yeah, start a I'm so mad now. I'm going to call my publicist. I can't even believe
call your publicist.
Leon Lemony.
Yes, yeah.
Do it.
Have a Hollywood hissy fit now.
Leon Lemony. Here two L's.
Here's the part where Leah finally works in that she says hi to us. Here we go.
Upset about later? Well, I wasn't upset about it until I heard the comments. And then I went, yeah, they're so right. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
so.
But as long as you say
I have some fans of yours watching, Don and Mike, they wanted me to say hello to you. They're radio guys and they love you. They wanted me to say hello.
Yeah, whose dress is this?
This is Hervé.
Listen to that. Aren't you great?
Yeah, so I mean, smart. And it was so hard. We really were able to discern how hard that was to do by watching that. I mean, I know it was hard to squeeze that in there.
Because when I say I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it.
That's
you
for
do.
Sure.
Yes, you do.
100% track record with that stuff.
I do. Absolutely.
Good.
Are you taping an episode today?
Am I what?
Are you taping an episode today?
Yes, we're taping tonight. I get to wear a wedding dress.
Oh, neato.
We're going back to when Doug and Carrie got married.
Oh, flashback show.
The only time you'll ever see me in a wedding dress.
Oh, please.
Really, Angelo's not going to make that happen?
I don't want a wedding, honey.
Oh, man. Oh, yes,
I don't want a wedding.
Yes,
am I not the dream girl? I said to him the other day, and I'm thinking he's going to get down on his knees and go, oh, my God, I knew I loved you, right?
Yeah.
I go, by the way, Angelo, I just want you to know that I don't want a wedding. And I'm thinking I'm going to hear, Leah,
you or something. You know, he goes, thank God for that.
Oh, God.
No, he's riding that Leah gravy train right now.
And I go, what the F are you saying? I mean, you should be ecstatic.
Mm-hmm.
I thought you were going to be teary-eyed and going, this is why I love you, honey. And he goes, because you'd be the biggest pain in the ass when it came to a wedding.
Was there any part of you, and I knew you answer me honestly every time I ask you any question, yeah, but I will tell you, was there any part of you that would have maybe liked to hear him say, well, you know, maybe we could visit that somewhere
any
down the road?
Any part of me, I had the script written out. I wanted him to say this.
Mm-hmm. She wants to get married to him.
There's nothing more. I want nothing more in life than to see you walking down the aisle. And you deserve a big wedding, Bubba.
Yeah,
But listen,
look at it from your boyfriend's perspective.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you've heard this. Why buy the cow when you're getting the milk for free? And especially when the milk
is... It's not that he doesn't want to marry me, Don. It's that I thought he would want, like, me to want a wedding. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I went all the way the other way, hoping that he'd fight me on it. He didn't. And then listen to this, my mother. Listen.
Your mom?
I told my mother the same thing, thinking my mother's going to say, Leah, Dar, I want to see my daughter walk down the aisle. She goes, good.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Why, Mom? I go, wouldn't you want to see me walk down the aisle? She goes, for what? Why would I want to see that? The amount of money you'd spend would be ridiculous, she tells me.
That's interesting. That's very unusual. Your boyfriend has an unusual point of view, and so does your mom.
Could you imagine?
I hope you can get through the heartbreak tonight of actually having to put a wedding dress on to film the episode of King of Queens.
No, I'm excited about it because it's the only time I'm probably going to wear it.
What color?
I'm very excited.
What color is Kevin's tuxedo going to be?
Probably black. I haven't seen
brown.
Yeah,
I was just wondering, it's like one of those pale blues.
Brown.
Oh, stop
it. We're going back to 1995, not 1980.
Oh, okay. All right, 95. Gotcha. All right.
Well, have a great taping. Thank you so much again for mentioning our names of that horse,
no
John
problem.
Rivers.
No problem. I'd do anything for you guys.
You know, we love you long time.
Thank you, baby. Love you a lot,
guys. Okay, bye, Leah.
Okay, bye, you guys.
Bye, there she goes.
Leah Remini is right over here.
A woman of her word.
There she is, Leon Lemony.
What are you wearing? Who are you wearing?
Duh. That's funny that Leah hadn't heard that Joan Rivers called her Leon Lemony.
You know she's calling her publicist.
You know that.
Do you like it when people say that you wear nice clothes?
Well, even though it's a very sad day in the history of Don and Mike fan dumb out there, we're going to turn it around.
Absolutely.
Today, we're having fun with Leah, and we're having fun on the show, but today's the day we had to cancel Forever Strip Trivia.
Yes. We did. There's a funereal air.
However, on Monday, we will have for you, with real professional women, women that you can count on, women who get naked to make their living. You can't count on the women who call to say they're going to play strip trivia.
Reliable women. That's strippers.
Right. That's right. They're coming down. And we're going to have strip pyramid.
Strip period?
Strip pyramid.
Pyramid.
All strip right. pyramid. In which six of our listeners will get a chance to win a Mercedes key with the teams of two pros playing each other.
All right.
Sorry about the strip trivia today. But, you know, the girls call and then they say they're going to come down. And then they don't come down. And you know, I'm not going to do the Rob thing and give them a knuckle sandwich. So all we can do is just cancel the show. I want to dedicate this, though, to the girls who canceled it today, okay?
First, we would never part.
Are you girls that called and said you were going to come down here today?
They drove us back like Texas to my heart.
And now never again, strip trivia.
You're the biggest cowgirl bitch I've ever seen.
Now we just got to get pros in here.
Stuffed into your tight blue Wrangler jeans.
Can't wait to see the pros, Don.
Well, I thought of every word from A to Z.
All you ladies that called and didn't show up.
But you put the in country.
Right. Amen.
Yeah, baby.
Amen. We got a break. We'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Have you seen the new intern? Extraordinary. Wouldn't I like to give her the old pork sausage? Hello, Jimmy Dean.
God
damn it.
Right, right.
The Don and Mike Show.
Right, right. Now listen, because we had to cancel the strip trivia because all those nasty C's out there that called and said they played and didn't show up. Well,
I mean, someone's going to win the key, the Mercedes key today.
All right. Someone out there who doesn't let us down.
Mm-hmm.
And we know that because you've listened to the show today.
We appreciate it.
Stand by for the call 100, and we'll have a real simple question.
Good.
Based on something happened on today's show, and you'll win the key for the Mercedes-Benz 230, the C230 compressor sports coupe from AT&T and Simply Wireless. Stop by one of their 36 convenient locations, Simply Wireless, this holiday season, or hit their website at www.simplywireless.com, and we'll make it up to you Monday.
Yeah.
When we're going to have the debut of the naked $20,000 pyramid with strippers, with real naked chicks playing.
Excellent.
Playing for you, the home listener.
Very good.
Six teams of two girls each playing the home version of the $20,000 pyramid.
Ooh. Each pair of women will be playing for a listener.
Yeah, that's right. And we'll have RJ, Raymond Diaz from Don and Mike Fans down here to get the pictures. And
very good.
Since they're strippers, there's no problem with, the stuff that we've gone through before with girls not wanting their photos on the web.
So right here in this studio, we will have two chairs facing each other.
That's right, and two naked chicks.
Wow. Absolutely.
Pros.
And they will be naked from the very beginning.
That's right.
None of this tedious question and answer, take your clothes off.
Now, we'll give you what you want. We promised you the naked chicks today,
mm-hmm.
and we did have one naked chick on the show. Please don't mention her name. That just might be our wacky question of the day. But we did have one naked girl down here today. She won the WWF trip. We've decided, we listen to our audience when they speak. And at least the females in the audience have told us that's it.
Yeah, we're tired of your amateur games.
You know, we played strip trivia for about 8 years on this show, and we're giving it up.
You know, it's something about the pros, you know. There's really no questioning with the pros. Yes. You know, they're guaranteed. They're reliable.
You know what you're going to get. You know that you're going to get hot, naked chicks.
That's right. Right.
And that's what we will deliver to you on Monday's episode.
And maybe some dumb answers.
Maybe so.
But I could be wrong.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Hi, who's this? Joel.
This is Joel from Baltimore, yeah.
Hi, Joel.
Hey, the other day you had V on there. She sang real good.
Yeah. Oh, and you should have seen her. Oh,
yeah. I think this young lady deserves a key to the car.
Yeah, you mean the topless girl?
We the fans of Donald Mike vote and think that she deserves a key. I don't know the young lady myself, but she sounded great.
Well, continue to vote, but leave the driving to us.
I think I think V's coming back in studio when we go back up to New York in a couple of weeks.
She certainly sounded like she wanted to
start the show again with another topless national anthem.
Oh, a good voice. Gentlemen, have a good weekend.
All right, thank you.
Bye-bye.
She had a great voice.
Right.
Bye-bye. She did have a nice voice.
Well, she had nice lungs.
Yeah. She did.
And a huge set of lungs.
Absolutely, could really hold a note.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hello.
Hi, you're on the air.
Hi, Don and Mike, this is John.
Hi, John.
How are you?
We're doing great, thank you.
Wondering if you could ask Rudy today what his relationship is with Big Shap.
That's a funny question.
Well, now, you know, as it turns out, and this is another thing that's a pisser about that. I'm sorry, I'm going on here about the strip trivia thing. But we moved all the Friday bits to Thursday.
Right.
So that we could do strip trivia today. So, anyway, and as we're not having Rudy on
you
today.
You cleared your docket, is what you're saying.
Yeah, cleared out the whole show for today. But so Rudy's not on. He would have been on yesterday when we would have had Dick Stockton on if Dick Stockton didn't demand a limousine to pick him up, even though he lives three blocks from the radio station. And Richard,
we dealt with a lot of handfuls this week.
Richard, the limo driver, got caught in traffic, and then Dick Stockton called and said that he couldn't walk three blocks to come be on the show.
I think it's just a generic message to anyone that's going to participate, anybody around the show at all. Leave early.
Yeah. Now, work on the, work on the Mike Douglas rule. Mike Douglas, and I read the autobiography. This is what a fag I am. My Story by Mike Douglas.
Right.
He had a rule, the five-minute rule. It was always 5 minutes early.
5 minutes early.
Always 5 minutes
early. Good policy. Absolutely.
That's right.
Well, I was wondering if you could just hold this maybe at bay for next week, but I was reading Dick Shapp's autobiography.
Yeah?
And he talks about, obviously, the sports reporters, and he says, each of us thinks of himself as exceptionally literate, yet we revel in the glory of our Sunday morning comments being reported on Monday mornings by USA Today's Rudy Marski.
Correct.
Borderline illiterate.
He really says that in his book?
Yep.
Oh, my God.
So Dick Shapp
In his book, he refers to Rudy Marsky as borderline illiterate.
Got it.
That is amazing. What a slam. Rudy must have slammed Dick Schaap sometime.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. But
he slammed him good. I think. I mean, this is no joke. I think Dick Schaap is like, well, one step away from taking a dirt nap.
No. Well, you know, Jeremy Schaap is his son. No, Dick's not working anymore?
No, I mean, no, Dick is sick.
Like, ill?
Dick is sick. Dick is like checkout sick.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, so maybe you can ask Rudy about that next time you talk to him.
I will. Okay. Maybe Rudy can stand up at Dick Schaap's funeral and say a few words about him.
Yeah, I like Dick.
How you doing?
He said I was illiterate. I ain't got no time for that.
Just want to ask him to read anything about Dick.
Yeah, Schaap. Someone have to read it to Rudy.
Yes, that's
all right. Thank you. Good call. Thank you, John.
Hello. You guys suck. Hello. No, I said it.
Oh, yeah. Glenn.
Glenn, you cut me off when I went to say you suck because...
Oh, Glenn, would you get off the phone, please? Big pain in the ass.
You suck so bad that you just can't stop calling the show.
Hello, Don and Mike show.
Let it go, Glenn.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, turn your radio down, please.
I'm sorry about that, guys.
That's okay.
Hey, I just came out of a meeting and I'm in my car right now. Did that girl from New York, the lawyer, did she ever come in?
No, of course she didn't.
No, she wasn't. She didn't intend to.
You're like all the girls who called over the last 2 days.
Hey, guys, you're doing a great job. I'm a New York listener, and I really just started listening to you. So,
you gotta
doing
be,
a great
you,
job.
That's why I want to just say something to you. All you guys out there, unless you find yourself a real cherry, like my girl Frida, you can't trust regular girls. The only girls you're going to find that you can trust in your life, unless you meet a real cherry like my Frida, it's going to be a pro. It's going to be a stripper. It's going to be a hooker.
Yeah, they won't let you down because they're doing it for money.
These are girls. I want to tell you something. These girls know the time is valuable. And if you call a hooker or you call a stripper and you say, be at the radio station at 11 o'clock.
Do you know what that clock says to them? That clock is like an ATM.
Correct.
That's it's right. Money.
It sounds just like my ex-girlfriend.
So what we had to do today was just cancel strip trivia altogether.
Your ex-girlfriend was a hooker?
Oh, no.
I mean a dancer?
She took my money like she was once.
Oh, sorry to hear that. All right, thanks for the call.
Good day, guys.
Yeah, and of course, the broad from New York, who we would have given a prize to anyway if she came in and took her clothes off.
Even though she sounded like she was 80 years old.
Right, she didn't do it either.
I can't find you.
Hello, Don and Mike show.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, you guys aren't doing the football picks today?
No.
Oh,
no.
Man, I wanted to hear Rudy get buzzed.
Get what?
Oh, get buzzed.
I wanted to hear the buzzer on Rudy. I live for that.
All right, well, look, next Friday, Rudy will be back on. Don't worry, next Friday, if he's still alive, we're going to try to get Dick Schaap on.
Oh, good.
to talk about how Rudy's illiterate.
I had no idea he was that ill.
Hello, Don and Mike. No, I mean, he's now, I don't want to say anything, but I think I'm not making a joke. He's like...
He's on the death's door?
Yes. Hello, Don and Mike show. It's not funny. Yeah.
No, but I mean, you're so serious when you say that. I didn't know. I wouldn't have mentioned it if I had
almost known. Dead. Hello, Don and Mike show.
Yeah, I was wondering which station are you on in Baltimore?
WJFK AM. That's my Schaap rap. Mm-hmm. That's my rap on
Schaap talk.
My rap on Schaap.
And his upcoming nap.
Hello, Don and Mike show.
Hey, I work for a local bottling company, and we would like to take Lisa's second pregnancy test and distill it and make a pee-pee pop.
And make a what?
A pee-pee pop.
A pee-pee pop.
A pee-pee.
Yeah. And the main ingredient will be corn syrup, so it'll be nice and yeller. And I think it's going to be good. It's going to be tart.
And you're going to eat it yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I forgot. We haven't given away at least a second EPT. Would you really like it?
Not really.
Yep. All right. Well, good.
Really.
Good for
all
you.
Right.
Good for you. Hello, Don and Mike show. Hello.
Oops. Which line? 2, 6.
Don and Mike show. Hello.
Yeah. Hi, Don.
Hi.
Can you get a janitor and a drum for that guy? Hello.
Can we get janitor and a drum for who? For Glenn the janitor.
For Glenn the janitor. He's driving me crazy.
No, I don't think so. Very similar, though.
Oh,
I thought it might have actually been a Glenn the Janitor call from Glenn the Janitor.
Oh, I'm insulted. Have a good day.
All right, thank you, my friend.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
That same kind of manic energy.
No, I don't think that was him.
Hey, guys.
We had one good death today on the show, one bad death.
Yeah, the death of strip trivia, bad death, the death of Glenn the Janitor, good death.
Good death. Mm-hmm. And Dick Schaap Well, that's not a formal.
Hey,
that's not a formal. Yeah,
only talking about Shap.
Dick Shap. Shut your mouth.
We can dig it.
Oh, here is Slow Joe Ardinger. Hello, Joseph.
Glenn just called in to tell me that this is war, and don't ever take another unscreened call because he's going to call like 100 times an hour now.
Great.
Glenn, get a life.
I said great. Thanks, dude.
Great.
Hello, Don and Mike Show. Yeah, we're trembling here. I just went number two in my pants. I'm so afraid that Glenn the janitor is going to continue to call this show.
Yeah, Glenn, because I really have a hard time recognizing you.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hi, Glenn and Mike.
Hey, Don.
How you doing, Curious?
Don Duck. Hi, hey, Don.
I'm doing pretty good.
How's that cold of yours?
Oh, it's been kind of bad.
Are you still sneezing a lot with that cold of yours?
Aren't you? Yeah.
Thank you.
I sure am.
Are you still banging Daisy?
How did you know?
Hey, put some pants on.
Okay, hold on.
Hey, do you feel like making a little whoopee on the show?
Well, yeah, okay. I want to.
Okay. All right, go ahead.
Okay, hold on. Come here, baby. Come here. No, it's your ass, Roman.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Don Duck.
Usually we get a Who's Your Daddy.
We never get sick of that. We never do. It's like the oldest joke, like the oldest tape in the world. So, isn't that like a 1950s tape of Donald Duck having sex?
Yeah, automatically makes me laugh.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hi, welcome to Wendy's. Would you like to try an old-fashioned combo?
This is so sad what's happened to the Grease Man.
Oh, is this Doug Track?
Yeah.
Who's this?
Hey, Doug, it's the Don and Mike Show.
Oh, hold on. Let me slip into my role as a boss jock.
Very good, Grease Man.
It's so sad. He used to be one of the top disc jockeys, the Grease Man, and now apparently, according to this call, he's working at Wendy's.
Anybody listening to the Grease Man used to be a fan of that show would not even recognize him as he is today.
Hey, Melwood Burbank, how about a little Bravo Mingus?
No thanks, Grease, but thanks for the offer.
Okay, Don, I have a confession to make. May I?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead, Grease Man.
Yeah, I know, Mike. You're waiting for the payoff. It'll come.
Yeah, don't worry, buddy. I'm not even going to ask you. I know you know what I like.
Oh, don't I? Okay.
Okay.
I realized that several weeks ago I confessed that I had lost my doodad. I must come clean with how that happened.
All right, how did you lose your doodads, Grease Man?
It was late one night on the good ship Grease, and which, by the way, is now the SS Minnow. I was there with my homosexual lover, which, by the way, is not Jim McClure.
Okay.
Don't you want to know who it is?
Who is it?
Yeah,
of course we do.
Who is it?
Oliver North.
Oh,
Oliver North.
Yeah, well, we knew about those right-wing politics.
Oh, don't I?
Yeah. Well, wonder what sounds you'd make with Oliver North.
See, for my money, he's still got the magic. I don't know why.
Does.
I don't know why the Grease Man's been blackballed out of our industry.
It's a shame. It really is.
I really don't. He's still a major talent.
He still has the same energy and great wit.
All right, thanks, Grease Man.
He's gone, Mike.
There he goes. Back to his job at Wendy's.
It was his dog, Blue.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Hi.
How you doing?
We're doing great, thank you.
Hi, Buzz.
Hi, how you doing?
Great.
What?
Well, that was great.
Hold on a second. Strip Pyramid.
Strip Pyramid happening Monday on the show.
Yeah, you got to, you can't just start naked. You got to have the disrobing as the show goes on.
No.
No, why? Doesn't that work for you? Why are you one of those guys that likes hearing the clothes come off?
No, it's like being at the beach and
well, I got a compromise for you. There's no reason why the ladies can't come in clothed, and then right before they're going to play the game, they remove their clothes.
Yeah, but listen, if they're pros, we should have naked chicks in here the whole time.
Yeah, they'll play the game entirely nude.
Yeah, but I can't imagine, you're talking men's candidates, I can't imagine it's going to take too long for the clothes to hit the floor, but But the whole thing with like watching a girl take cutoffs off his beach, you know, it's the whole titillation factor.
You know, there's lots of guys wow. that get into like I know why strip trivia is so popular, that it's the whole thing of like stripping.
And I think that there will be stripping. I mean, they obviously are not going to walk down the hallway here at the facility.
Oh, they're not. They're not going to get out of their cars naked.
Only if you ask.
But the game won't lend itself to that. We will play it the right way, and you can rent a video.
All right, thank you, though. Bye-bye. And you'll be able to go to DonandMikeFans.com on sure. Monday afternoon and see the pictures of real hot naked chicks. Mm-hmm. Again, well, you know, my own cherry wife not being included, or any of the other wives here. But those are the only women I'm finding you can really count on.
That's right. Yeah. 100% reliable.
Ethical people.
100% guaranteed.
Hookers and strippers.
You moron.
And our wives.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, hi. How do I get to speak to Don?
I'm here right now. I've just answered the telephone. Hello?
Yes, hi.
Is this Glenn the janitor, Mike?
Pardon me?
No. It's not okay. Hi, what can I do for you?
No, I just wanted to tell you how I enjoy your show.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
And my husband really loves your show, and we have great sex after he listens to you.
Well, fantastic.
Well, thank you for calling.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Mia.
All right. He would have too much ego to go away. Like,
yeah, he would have had to say, this is... And let's not even refer to him by name anymore.
Right?
It
would have to have... It has far too much ego to let a conversation with it go by without it saying something.
Hello, Mike.
Hey.
Hey, Donna, Mike Show.
Bunch, how you doing?
Hey, we're doing great, thanks.
Hey, you got to cut that tape when your wife was calling in earlier today. The only thing she kept saying was, yeah, and then I had to go in there and talk to the judge time and time again.
Okay, all right, I got you.
See you later, bud.
I get it. Talk to the judge. I get jokes. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, this is William.
Hi, William.
Yeah, I'm in Fredericksburg. Yeah, I just wanted to call and say that...
Hey, William?
Yeah.
Where are you?
Home.
Yeah, but where are you? What town are you in?
Fredericksburg.
Ah, okay. Right. What can we do for you, William?
Yeah, I just wanted to call and say I've been listening to your show for almost 10 years now, and it's sad to see strip trivia go because I heard the first one.
Wow. Well, listen, William, we're all sad, but let's face it. Outside of, you know, our cherry wives, there's no women in the world you can count on.
Yeah, true.
Well, you know, the only women, and I'm going to say this right now, all you women out there, you're all big C's.
Exactly.
With the exception of the working women of America.
And our wives.
Yes. The strippers. The hookers. The exotic dancers.
Absolutely.
These are the women who will not let down a nationally syndicated radio show. And the millions of men who all week long have been saving up their love juice. Waiting to spread the beach towel.
Just two more days, fellas. Just have a nice quiet weekend. And you won't be disappointed on... We are doing it on Monday, right?
Yes.
You won't be disappointed on Monday.
Discipline yourselves. Discipline yourselves this weekend.
Right.
No release this weekend. And Monday will be a glorious day.
Bravo.
Y'all are hilarious. Radio gods.
Thank
See
you for
later.
The call. Thanks. See you later. Bye.
Y'all are great.
Hi, thank
and I'm
you.
I'm talking to you, sir, and all your friends in Fredericksburg.
You know, he brought up something that I hadn't thought of in a while, and I think it might bring a smile to your face.
What?
The first strip trivia, do you remember who the contestants were?
Was it one L. Sid?
No. The first one was Lenora McMillan and Earl Merton.
Oh, my God.
That's right, two station employees.
Yeah, we actually went with employees.
It was like a test balloon.
Yeah, and it worked.
Do you remember?
Wow.
Do you remember how bad it smelled?
It was horrible in here.
How bad it smelled when Lenora took her underpants off?
Yeah, it was bad.
I'm not kidding.
Well, pantyhose, and I think it might have been foot.
Whoa. Hello, Tim.
Hey, Don and Mike.
Yeah, hi.
How you doing? First time caller, new listener.
Thanks.
I just want to ask a simple question.
Yeah.
If you guys were a car part, what parts would y'all be? Because I'm trying to learn the show and... You know, trying to figure out, I mean...
I'll tell you right now, Buzz is the brake.
That's right. Always have been. Pretty much dead kidding. Weight over here.
Kidding, because I love.
Right.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
What car part would you be?
The gas. No, I think I'd be the accelerator.
Mm-hmm. I would be the hood ornament. Hi, everybody.
Thank you, Rob. Hello, Don and Mike Show. Hello, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, Jeff, hi, you're on the air.
Yeah, hey, this is Jeff calling from New York. I wanted to remind Don and Mike that
But remember, radio is like TV for the blind man. We want to hear the women getting naked. Having them already naked in the studio.
Well, no, we had just said they're not going to come walking in here naked. They will be taking their clothes off.
They will be under,
and we will be telling you about them taking their. We'll be describing what they're wearing as they remove it.
All right. Well, that's the best part of the show.
There you go.
All
right. I know this is important. I can tell by the tone of these calls.
We'll handle it. You'll like it on Monday.
All right.
Save up your seat all weekend.
All righty.
Okay. Thanks. Bye bye. Trust me. Monday, Explosion City. Hello, Carlson.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey.
Hey,
you can't say the S word.
Can't say the S word.
Hey, I forgot about that. I'm just a little tight today, you know?
Okay. What'd you say? Why don't we throw S at who?
At that Glenn dude, man. You know, tied to a tree or something like you guys used to do to Luthor.
That
would give him what he wanted.
Besides, he's all the way up in New York, and we're back in D.C.
Yeah, and he wants as much exposure as possible.
Hello, we got a break. Last
please
call.
It. Call him it.
Don and Mike show. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, you're on the air.
Oh, hey, Don and Mike, how you guys doing?
We're doing great.
Buzz, how you doing?
All right, how are you?
I think your problems will be solved by keeping the flavor of the, strip trivia. I think everybody still wants that whole description of the clothes coming off. If you guys
okay,
come out...
listen, guys, we hear you, okay? Mm-hmm. If one thing, we do listen to our audience, we do respond to our audience, we will find a way to keep the element of stripping in the game.
Right.
We'll figure it out, okay? Mm-hmm. I promise.
Okay.
So save your seed. SYS all weekend. Save it up, and on Monday, I promise you, you're going to have to buy a Windex.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Okay?
You guys do a great job.
Thank you for the call. Hello, absolute last call. Don and Mike. Hello, Scott.
Don and yes. Mike. Oh, my God. This is a sad day for the long-term listener.
Oh, well, you
strip
mean...
Strip trivia is dead.
Yeah, strip trivia is dead.
Can't believe this. I have one small, humble request.
What's that?
Would you play the song one more time?
No. No.
Please.
You have to wait till the box set comes out.
Give it a proper burial.
No. No. I'm sorry.
You kill something on this show, Don. You notice there are a lot of people that, with the helpers. It gives them some kind of indication that they're needed. No, they're not. No help necessary.
All right. Well, then I would just like to send out a big FU to all the girls that caused this to happen.
Absolutely.
Amen, brother.
I'm with you. Thank you, my friend.
Burn in hell.
Thank you. Amen.
A lot of anger out there.
May their privates burn in hell.
Oh, my.
Right on! That's what I want. Now, listen. We do have good news for those of you who have faithfully listened through this non-strip trivia show today.
Faithfully.
We do have a key that can start the Mercedes-Benz C230 compressor sports coupe.
It's got a beautiful hood ornament.
One of only 29 keys we're giving away. I got a question about something that happened on the show right here.
Easy.
Right here.
Easy.
877-365-3636, 202-432-1067. Call 100, you get first shot at the key. Good luck.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
This is absolutely gross. That boy is a...
Hey, Rob, come here and feel this. The Don and Mike Show.
Oh, yeah, we're not going to let you down on Monday. I just talked to Lisa from a variety of establishments.
Fantastic.
Monday on this show, 12 hot naked strippers.
All right. Yeah.
Playing the Naked Pyramid. And each set of two naked chicks, and yeah, guys, they'll be stripping on the show.
Yes, they're right. Coming here clothed.
They're gonna be playing each team of two strippers. We'll be playing for a member of the audience.
Very exciting.
So six random callers have a chance to win the Mercedes key on Monday's episode.
Great.
Strip trivia is dead. However, long live the Naked Pyramid.
The Naked Pyramid.
Yeah. With pros.
Mm-hmm.
That is on Monday's episode. I've just gotten the information about our next bowling match. Come see the Don and Mike Gutter Balls take on the all-gay team, the Bowling Ballers.
That's next week?
That's Wednesday night, Mike. And it's at AMF in Annandale, Virginia.
We're returning to AMF in Annandale.
Yes, we are.
Oh, we love it.
There will be drag queens there.
Very good.
And the big bet is if we lose, we go with them to famous gay bar, Wet. And if we win, they go with us to the Camelot.
Ah, very good.
Which is, of course, a straight bar full of the type of women you can count on.
That's very good.
Strippers. So that's next Wednesday night. Dynamite Gutter Balls against the Bowling Ballers, the all-gay team, Wednesday night, 8 o'clock at the AMF in Annandale.
AMF.
Like to see you there. Okay, let's give away. What do you say? Let's give away the key, today's key, for the Mercedes, since we didn't give it away with the women on the strip trivia. Hello, Don and Mike Show. Who is this?
Caller 100.
Yes, you are, but please, what be thy name?
Ronald Dexter.
Ronald Dexter. Where are you from, Ronald?
Alexandria, Virginia.
All right, I hope you've been listening to the whole show today. Have you?
Yeah, I have.
Good. Really?
Yeah.
Okay, here you go. Real simple question. You know, we didn't play strip trivia.
Yeah, yeah.
But one girl did come down, and she's a beautiful, hot girl. Mm-hmm. She took her clothes off. What was her name?
Beautiful flower by the name of Rose.
There it is!
Yeah!
There it is!
That's right.
That's how simple it is.
Yeah.
It's Rose.
This is the Rose theme.
And you, my friend, listen, you've won the key that could start the Mercedes-Benz C230 Compressor Sports Coupe.
All right!
The hottest new car from Mercedes. Hey, you want to buy one of these babies? 6-month waiting list.
Yeah.
Your choice of color, interior, you name it. And the car is courtesy of AT&T and Simply Wireless. This holiday season, when shopping to buy a wireless phone, stop by one of the 36 convenient locations of Simply Wireless or hit their website at simplywireless.com. And we'll see you on Friday, December 14th, for the giant key party.
Okay.
If your key starts the car, you drive out with the car. Thank you for listening. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, okay. Hold on a second.
Thank you, Ronald. He's stunned.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
That's Ronald from Alexandria.
Okay. You know, we had planned on doing the big elaborate strip trivia thing today, but what can I say?
Worked out.
Yeah, bitches let us down.
And I'm looking forward to Monday.
Yeah, well, Monday. That's right. First time ever. It's going to be the debut of the strip pyramid game.
Now, will it be the naked pyramid or the strip pyramid?
I think it's going to be strip pyramid.
Strip pyramid.
Strip pyramid.
I just did it too. I don't know why it's happening, but I'm saying it and I can't control it.
If you watch the $20,000 pyramid, trust me, you're going to like it, and it's going to work out great with strippers. And six different audience members will have a chance to win the key. That's on Monday's episode. Now, I know that we didn't do the Pick the Pros thing today because we had the whole schedule screwed up to do it yesterday. But we do have a football segment for you NFL fans out there. Joining me now, of course, is
how are you?
The owner. The owner of the Washington Redskins.
Success.
Daniel M. Snyder.
So, real sorry about, your strip trivia going by the boards. I guess you kind of lost that one. I don't know how that feels, because I'm on a winning streak.
Yeah,
there you are. Ooh, I'm a winner. Go, Danny. And I hope you don't have any more losses, because, frankly, I'm making noise about having both of you thrown out of the building.
Now, really, you're going to have Mike and I fired?
Well, I just think that, I like to fire people, and then now that we're turning the corner, and I'd like to make a bold prediction.
All right, make your bold prediction.
The Redskins will go to the Super Bowl this year.
Wow.
Based on that win, yes, we're on a winning streak. If they don't, I will remove all my elevator shoes. And you know how difficult that is for me because I'm chased by cats. You know, that's really bad.
I'll tell you something real funny about the real Dan Snyder. Funny?
The real Dan Snyder? He's sitting right here.
At FedEx Field last week?
Yes, Tom.
He was interviewed by Deion Sanders on the CBS show with Nancy.
I remember that interview.
And they really made him stand on a box.
Yes. Yes, it's true. And I was wearing my elevator shoes, too. You know, I have to do that. All the ex-jocks. That's why I've always said, why do we have to have ex-jocks do all the interviews? Why can't we have ex-circus performers? Why does it always have to be the guys that played? Mr. Tall Man. I'm Mr. Money Man. And I'm doing real well.
You're pompous. You know, the Redskins...
3-5, baby.
Are still... Listen, love them, but they're still one of the worst teams in the NFL.
Well, we are favorites now for the Eastern Division of the NFL. In the NFC, National Football Conference. I'll tell you right now, I feel very good about this team. I feel very good about myself. I feel very good about everything. And I'm very confident.
You know,
and I think everybody should be confident.
During the five-game losing streak, you came in and you were...
Losing streak, schmoozy. That's ancient history. Look forward, man.
You were humble during the losing streak, and now you seem to be pompous, arrogant.
Yeah, well, I was out at the park today, and one of the new secretaries, who I hired after I fired the old ones, came in and said, boy, I hope you can turn it around. And I fired her. Turn it around. We have turned it around. I am so confident. And let me tell you, if we go to the NFC Championship, you two are gone. Out.
Wow.
Out.
Fired.
Yeah, you're fired.
We're fired.
Because I'll own this city again, just like I did when I bought the team.
Is it true that you're, what is that, the Malibu Barbie Corvette? Is that the car you're driving now?
I drive the Malibu Barbie Corvette some of the time. I drive the Olsen Twins Jeep. That is another fantastic vehicle. I comb my hair with the little plastic brushes, the little brushes that they have there. And I have a very good time.
And I hear on the weekend you like riding My Little Pony.
I do. Oh, I love My Little Pony because I'm an outdoorsman. I'm an accomplished outdoorsman. I have a fantastic time. I really enjoy all these things. And I tell you, after I fired this secretary, I said, get me another one. And the number one quality, they have to take shorthand.
Well, you hear him. He's very pompous. He's the owner of the Washington Redskins.
Thank you.
And I know the joke that everybody, of course, is saying is, you know, we guarantee the Redskins cannot lose this weekend. The Redskins cannot lose this weekend.
They cannot lose. They are going to win guaranteed because it's a bye week.
It's
I know that.
Yeah, okay.
But I'll tell you right there, I'm taking the week off. I'm going to go away, spending the weekend at Barbie's Dream House.
Barbie's Dream House.
Looking forward to it. I really am. We're going to be great. I'm making a strawberry shortcake for everybody once again with my Easy Bake Oven.
Of course you are.
So big. No, it's like industrial size. It's like one of those big pizza ovens. Having a good time. Hope I don't get caught in anybody's cuffs. I hate that when that happens. Really. I got stuck in the screen. Last time I went to Barbie's Dream House. Hey, Buzz.
How are you? Didn't you get shoved in somebody's dookie one time?
You said you weren't going to bring that up.
I thought that happened to you when you were in San Francisco.
I was put in there.
Oh, no.
Somebody mistook me for a small animal. I was wearing my brown fur.
In a world where owning a radio was strictly forbidden, one man found a way to bring good news to his people.
Was Burbank.
He made it up.
You see, Daniel Snyder. He's very short.
Well, they tried string around my feet and put me up there and then yanked me back out.
Wow.
Again and again. Again.
Buzz, what is your lead story on the news and comments tonight?
Today, some famous sportscasters get a scare in the air.
Okay.
Ooh, scare in the air. My scare in the air is one time when I was picked up by a robin.
Okay, stay tuned, everybody.
Stay tuned for the news and comments
coming up
on the Don and Mike Show.
And Daniel, that was very...
professional like me. So long, losers.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
People.
You can call Don and Mike anytime, toll free at 1-877-365-3636. That's 1-877-365-3636. They're ready to believe.
Right. That's the national number, 877-365-3636,
DC 202-432-1067. What's the word for playing crackback?
I will find out now.
Try listening in the fart sack, the Don and Mike Show.
Here he is, Guy Birdley. Hi, Buzz.
Hi, Don and Mike. It was quite a day yesterday for NBC sportscasters Hannah Storm, Dan Hicks, and Jim McKay. They and some NBC sports executives were on their way out of Salt Lake City when the private jet they were in lost communications with the ground. These days, that's more of a problem than it used to be.
I bet.
The next thing they knew, their plane was being escorted by F-16 fighter jets. The military jets landed the Gulf Stream, escorted it to a landing after intercepting it over the Great Salt Lake. Once the sportscaster's jet radio was repaired, the group was finally able to return to New York.
They were all naked in the jet.
Exactly.
Hannah and Jim McKay.
And Jim McKay had bigger boobs.
That's right. And their butts were bleeding.
A 16-year-old girl in Latvia is facing charges of endangering the life of a high official. She could get 15 years in prison
for slapping Prince Charles in the face with a flower.
Prince Charles was high?
No.
He's a high official.
He's a high-ranking official.
Hello.
The law is worded.
So nice to see you. I was wondering if there's a chance I could get the Oreos. Could I have a bag of Oreos, please?
Hi, this is Buzz Burbank. Whenever I'm in Washington or New York, I listen to the Joe Show.
Speaking of high officials.
Yes, I've just landed in D.C. May I speak with Mr. Joseph Aldinger, please?
Oh, you need your weed.
Yes, I do.
And your pharmaceuticals.
I need my Vike.
Your Vicodin?
Get my Vike. I need a Vike fix.
The prince was not injured by the flower.
I couldn't feel the flower.
The girl who was protesting the bombing of Afghanistan is still in jail awaiting her trial. Some government computers are so lacking in security measures, they don't even have passwords.
They don't even have passwords.
And that's even 2 months after the first attacks on America. House lawmakers in Washington say computers in the Defense Department, along with computers at the Energy and Justice Departments, get a failing grade for their ability to ward off hackers.
I don't even have an opinion.
The National Science Foundation got the best grade, a B+.
All right.
Over 200 pro-choice groups and clinics got...
I'm going to give you now some of my passwords.
Oh, okay, good.
Ideas
for the government?
Yeah, some passwords. These are some that I've had.
Oh, okay.
And maybe the government would like to use these as passwords. They say it's best to go with a bunch of short words rather than something like your birthday or one word. So I've gone with this one.
Yeah. There was going to be some kind of punishment.
Okay, I've gone
some
with that
kind
one.
Of punishment.
Okay, that's one. Here's another one.
Not too annoying.
Not too annoying is another one of these.
Here's one.
Oh!
That was hard to write
down. I know.
That's like H-I-I-E-E-E-E-H-H-H. E-E-H-H-H.
See, that's why you can crash into my computers all the time.
I know.
Master hacker, you are.
It's all about listening.
Not a chance.
Not a chance is another one.
There you go.
I believe he is a dumb.
Okay.
That's the easy one.
There's not a chance.
Variation on another one.
Right.
He's the schoolyard bully.
That schoolyard bully is for your really secure computer.
Right.
What happened?
I know, that's an easy one. You always remember that. What's my password? Oh, yeah, what happened?
It's your laptop.
Yeah.
Yeah, bitch slapping.
Bitch slapping is your porn site.
There you go.
Who cares?
Okay.
Who cares is the WJFK site?
Pack of lies.
That also just a subset of the JFK.
Why?
Okay. Again, JFK site.
Right.
She does have a nice rack, though. I'll give that to her.
That's when I go to one of my porn sites.
Mm-hmm.
I think I might.
That's the grand password.
That's when I go to a porn site also. I think I might.
I do, Richie.
Listen, I could go on and on.
They're limitless.
I've got so many different AOL
accounts.
Those
are all good.
AOL, the thing about AOL is you can have like 8,000 different screen names.
Absolutely.
I've got so many names and so many passwords.
That's not good.
Well, that's one of my passwords. That's not good.
She gets around. Round.
That's what I'm about for the porno.
If there were no Matt Damon, no Ben Affleck.
Right.
Yeah, that's a confusing one. Hard to crack, though.
Sure is.
Over 200 pro-choice groups and clinics got powder in the mail yesterday. The FedEx letters contained a substance that resembled, but wasn't, anthrax. The Daily News quotes one recipient as saying, "This is a direct murder threat." Similar letters arrived at about 280 clinics 3 weeks ago. Yesterday's letters were signed by a radical anti-abortion group called the Army of God.
They had to fry those people.
And they're postmarked Philadelphia and Northern Virginia.
Northern Virginia? Come on in.
That's right here.
Come on in.
Five truckloads of mail bound for Washington, D.C. finally arrived and returned to the city after a side trip to Ohio for decontamination. But there have been problems. The company hired to decontaminate the mail can only do letters. So the packages are coming back untreated.
But we don't wear suits.
And some of the mail will have to be repackaged before it can finally be delivered to its destination a month late.
The Red Cross.
Get to know Charlie.
Thanks for coming to Charlie and Joe's Decontamination Center.
Get to know Charlie.
Joe, we got another mail truck down here.
I'm sorry, Charlie.
Okay.
I screwed up again.
You did. La-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Let's get busy.
Get to know Charlie.
I got a cough. Oh, shit. Me have fever.
The Red Cross is promising to account for every penny of its $500 million September 11 fund. It had to make that promise after growing criticism and tough talk from lawmakers, after word got out that almost half the money might not go to victims of the attacks. Americans donated enthusiastically to the fund with the understanding that all the money would go to the victims, And the victims themselves say they've seen little or none of the money, and they complain about the red tape involved in getting it.
Get it? Red tape? Red Cross?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Right, got it.
Quoting New York's attorney...
Hunt for Red October, Red Grange? Mm-hmm. That's right.
Quoting New York's attorney general, we will not be satisfied until...
Big Red?
Angry Red Duke?
Big Red Machine?
Red Skins?
Red Skeleton?
Red Legs?
Red Light? Red Head?
Red...
Red Wings?
Red McCombs.
I gotta be king of the Reds. I'm a mouth
red,
ahead of you.
Red Skeleton?
Red Socks.
Red Buttons.
You should have had Red Socks.
You're king of the Reds. You got me like by six.
King of the Reds. Hey, how you Reds doing?
Quoting New York's Attorney General, we will not be satisfied until every penny of that $564 million goes to the victims. That was clearly the intent of those who gave so generously. Bill Maher believes he is going to be fired.
Oh, well, there's some good news.
You hear that? You hear that, Bill Maher? You're going to be fired. If he bangs her any harder, the airbags are going to explode.
The host of ABC's late-night show Politically Incorrect angered people by saying the terrorists were braver than the United States. Quoting him,
that stupid pussy.
We have been the cowards lobbing cruise missiles from 2,000 miles away. That's cowardly, staying in the airplane when it hits the building.
Say, oh, tell him he can come up inside my teenage colon.
Say what you want about that, it's not cowardly, end quote. Viewers complained, big sponsors pulled their ads, local stations dropped the show, and Maher says his relationship with the network has turned chilly. But he doesn't sound sorry. Quoting him again, I'm not going to change. He's only apologized, and I quote, to anyone who took it wrong.
Yeah, you know, I do that sometimes with Frida, and that doesn't work.
No, it doesn't.
You know, because what you say is, hey, if you were offended by that, I'm sorry. Yeah. You know, or if...
I'm sorry you got mad.
Yeah.
The greatest, you know, and I've said probably more in arguments.
Yeah. That's the way to say it. Not to say, I guess what originally I screwed up because
right.
What you should say is, if you're offended, I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
But what you said is the doublespeak way.
Yeah, I am sorry. I'm sorry you got mad. I'm sorry you got upset with me.
Or I'm sorry if you misunderstood.
I'm sorry if you misunderstood.
That doesn't work.
When really, how big a deal is it for the guy to come out and say, I'm sorry for my insensitive, foolish comments for the circumstance.
That's
all he had to say.
Standing his unemployed ground.
I mean, he didn't... It's not a question of whether you feel any way about it.
Right.
It was wrong to say it at the time.
That's right.
Dumbass.
We have no better friends than the Brits when it comes to the war on terrorism, but they've been having some fun taking jabs at our action hero movie stars. Tom Cruise says he admires New Yorkers who continue to go to work, but British actor Richard Harris points out that Cruise has... canceled the publicity tour for his upcoming movie, despite his 8 bodyguards.
Hey, Richard Harris. Nice funeral. I mean, he's coming soon.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, I'm just being pro-American here.
Good for
Richard
you.
Harris should issue an apology for recording MacArthur Park.
Someone left the cake out in the rain.
Isn't he in the Harry Potter movie? Is it Richard Harris in the Harry Potter movie?
No. Hell no, we don't get any limeys in there. Not allowed.
Well, I think he is. I think he plays the sorcerer.
Well, how the hell did that slip through the cracks, by God?
I don't know, but it's Harry Potter here with us now.
We're still going to take a dirt nap together, me and Richard Harris.
How's his daughter doing, Richard Harris's daughter?
What's his daughter's name?
Colette
Harris. Doesn't she work out at your front desk? Hello, Miss Harris.
She does. Good boy.
London tabloids have blasted Arnold Schwarzenegger for recently backing out of a trip to Europe out of, quote, security concerns. And they've blasted Bruce Willis for not going to the British premiere of his movie Bandits. One paper used the headline, Cry Hard.
Yeah, but you got great actors over there in Britain, like Hugh Grant.
Britain Sting and David Frost flew into New York yesterday from London for the relaunch of the Concord service.
Can you be cold, Batman?
Hold on.
All right.
We got a break. I hate to get down on Britain because they are really our best friends.
They are.
But they should just shut up. And remember that in all the great wars we fought, that was one of the sweetest when we beat your British asses.
Yeah, have a piece of boiled steak.
Don't forget that. I mean, you're still our friend. Don't forget we beat your ass. We'll be right back.
They can handle the fact that every day you're confronted with the ugly side of humanity. They can handle murder, rape, and deceit. They can handle just about anything the job throws their way. Until now.
Now we need it here today.
It's the home of the Glastonbury Golden Boys. The Don and Mike Show.
Oh, we made it through today all right with a train wreck that was strip trivia. Yeah, we hung in there. Yeah. And Monday's episode, you're going to love this. The debut of Strip Pyramid. Strip Pyramid.
Yay.
It's a $20,000 pyramid with real-life pros, strippers, naked chicks.
Fantastic.
12 of them in the studio.
All right.
Six teams of two girls each.
Wow.
And six listeners get a chance to have a key that could start the Mercedes. Oh, and also Monday, you're going to love this, the debut of Where's Dude Walker? That's on Monday's show.
Very exciting.
We're always using our heads, always thinking ahead.
Where's Dude?
Give you the best possible entertainment. 877-365-3636. 202-432-1067. Caller 100 right now. Prize package selected especially for you. Really, the strip pyramid thing. That's going to be great.
It's going to be hot.
The Where's Dude? That's like a one-time joke. Okay.
All right. Hi, Buzz.
Hi, Don and Mike. I'm here.
Maybelicious actress Elizabeth Hurley's pregnant.
Nice push.
Sorry, guys in the Beach Style Club. She's
that's a shame.
Carrying the child of producer friend Stephen Bing.
Oh, but she's going to get those big tig bitties.
Yeah.
When she fills up with milk.
Thank you. And thank you for that biology class.
So that's how she feeds the babies.
That's how that works.
Yeah.
Through her breasticles.
You know what? You don't have to go back to class now.
And they fill up with milk.
That's it.
And because they get full of milk, they get bigger.
Yes, they do.
It's amazing.
It's fantastic.
Right.
Hurley is...
Many of the women in that calendar would know that. In the Butterball calendar.
The ladies of the Butterball talk line calendar.
Oh, wow. Hurley's no longer dating Mr. Bing. It was former lover Hugh Grant who accompanied her to the hospital for a checkup. When Hurley and Grant went at him a couple of years ago, she said she didn't think she'd make a very good mother.
Yeah.
The 36-year-old Hurley denied being pregnant at first, but after being seen wearing baggy clothing, she is said to be absolutely thrilled.
Oh, yeah.
And Jennifer Aniston isn't pregnant, but tried telling that to some of the people who watch Friends. Aniston says she and Brad Pitt were having dinner the other night when they were approached by the wait staff bearing chocolate cake and congratulations.
Yep.
Aniston says their first clue should have been that she was drinking sake and smoking a cigarette at the time.
Well, she could have been Lisa Herndon. Radio's number one producer.
Thank you.
George Harrison is very, very sick. The former Beatle was in a New York hospital over the weekend getting experimental cancer treatments for the tumors in his lung and brain. A hospital source tells the New York Post Harrison checked in under his wife's name and that he had at least one visitor, fellow former Beatle Ringo Starr.
Oh, I thought it'd be Dick Schaub going to see him.
No. He's in the next room.
Oh, dear.
Well, heavy-duty
music.
I can't take that, man. I can't take strip trivia and George Harrison the same day.
No way.
You got to make it through the weekend, George.
Absolutely.
Former Dallas star Larry Hagman says that when he dies, he wants his body stuffed into a wood chipping machine. And his,
of course it does.
And his remains spread over a field.
Hey, Jeannie.
Then he says he wants to be plowed into the soil and to have wheat planted there.
Of course, he's nuts.
And then,
God, he's a maniac.
Then he says the wheat would be made into flour, and the flour would be used to bake a big cake that would be served to all of his friends.
Oh, that is disgusting.
Quoting Hagman, it's a good idea to recycle yourself. Hagman also...
Eat me!
Eat me.
Hagman also says he once rented a private plane, flew it over the Columbia Pictures studio lot, and urinated out the door. Hagman, who was making I Dream of Jeannie at the time, was upset with Columbia about something.
Hey, I want to take a private plane up there and just urinate out the door. That's all I want to do, Jeannie.
But it might be more appropriate if he takes the wheat and turns it into liquor.
Corn liquor.
Yeah, corn liquor, you can drink it. He must have just been a little mad. I think if you're really mad, you rent a plane, you go up there and you...
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
You know, he's probably just saying he urinated, but you know, you're renting the private plane, you're doing number one and two.
All over Bonanza.
Absolutely.
It's a good thing he didn't, because he says the...
Hey, what landed outside of my cabana window?
The good thing he didn't do number two, because he says the urination prank backfired. He says the wind blew the urine back into the plane.
Oh, look at that. I have my little military pants, my Air Force pants.
A Chicago radio station's canceled its Britney Spears contest. That city's Kiss FM was offering $5,000 for breast enhancement. Female listeners were urged to submit a photo of themselves and a 50-word explanation of why they should win. Quoting the promo, "Want to be like Britney? You first met her on the Mickey Mouse Club. You watched her grow into every guy's fantasy slave. Now you want what she's got." The station pulled the ad this week after a flood of complaints.
We've given away breast implants before. What's the big friggin' deal there?
Who cares?
In sports, no big deal. Sacramento continues its road trip tonight with a stop in Orlando. The Kings suffered their first loss in five games. Wednesday to Indiana, the Magic are 2-3. And finally, police in Tokyo have arrested a Japanese mobster, not for murder or conspiracy or racketeering.
Hello, this is Mr. Chu. Hi, I'm Jimmy Ching.
They set out to arrest him.
Johnny Ching.
Hi, Johnny.
They set out to arrest him.
It'd be better if it was Ching. Sing, no, sing is good. You're Johnny Ching. You're Johnny Ching.
You're Jackie Ching.
Bang.
They set out to arrest him initially for trying to look up a woman's skirt. When police confronted the mobster, he drew a weapon and shot two officers. They were wounded but not incapacitated. They arrested the mobster anyway for more than just looking up a skirt. I'm Buzz Burbank on the Don and Mike Show.
Thank you, Buzz.
No! Yeah!
Right, I couldn't have said it better myself. All right, listen, have a great weekend, everybody. Don't hurt yourself. Love you, Frida, love you, Barn. Thank you for listening. Thank you for all the great phone calls today. The Craft World Tour continues. Join Tom Gavin at the Second Street Cafe at Scenic Warrington, Virginia. Please come out tomorrow night, 9 p.m. to 1 a.m. for the Mike O'Mara Band.
I don't want to sound desperate, but please!
That's the Craft Blues Band. This weekend, treat yourself. Join Rob Spiewak and Lisa Herndon at Cozone in Reston, Virginia. That's tomorrow, Saturday, 1 to 3 p.m. They'll be there to give away prizes in addition to unbridled joy. Leah Remedy's TV show, King of Queens, Monday night, 8 o'clock on CBS. Our thanks to Simply Wireless and AT&T for supplying the Mercedes-Benz C230 we're giving away. Hit their website, www.simplywireless.com. F you to all the girls who said they were coming down today and didn't come down. And go! May your privates really get inflamed. And bad stuff happened down there. Monday, it's the debut.
The debut
of the Strip Pyramid. Get some real pros down here. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, on the 100.
Yeah. Ha, ha, ha. Great. Who's this, please?
This is Mike the Grabber.
Mike, where are you from?
I'm from Germantown.
Mike, you won the Butterball Turkey Talk Line 2000 calendar.
All right.
Oh, J.O. material all the way. Call 1-800-BUTTERBALL or go to butterball.com. But wait, there's more. You've also won. No, I take it back. That's it.
That's it.
No, hold on. WWF Survivor Series. In your home, in demand, on Saturday, November 18th at 8 p.m., call Comcast or Cox Cable now to order this pay-per-view event. Enjoy!
Thank you very much.
And also our thanks to New York Yankees manager Joe Torre, who was our newsmaker of the week.
He was indeed, Captain.
All right, everybody, we will see you on Monday. Have a great weekend, won't you, please? Thank you, and good day to you, sir.
Good day to you, sir.
Thank you, good day to you, sir.
Good day to you, sir.
Good day to you, sir.
I said good day.
Please. He's your hat in the air, just like Sidney. Tyler Moore. You might just make it after all. Oh! All right, so close.
No,
see you Monday. Bye-bye.
Till we meet again. This is Sammy Davis Jr. saying, be kind, be nice, and I hope the next performer has the pleasure of having as nice an audience as you've been tonight. And let me leave you swinging.